means the birth of hope and dreams in college football. But in College Station, it means more than that in 2003. Dennis Franchione's Aggies are about to embark on a journey that they hope will lead to the land of college football's elite.
I believe we can win the Big 12 South, and I believe we can challenge at the highest level, and that's why I wanted to coach at Texas A&M.
It's not just any season opener in Aggieland. The much-anticipated Dennis Franchione era begins next. August 30th circled on the calendar for quite some time, and folks, good news. The wait is almost over. About 10 minutes away from kickoff at Kyle Field is the 2003 season about to get underway, and a new season and a new era it is for the Texas A&M Aggies as they play host to the Indians of Arkansas State. I'm Kevin Eschenfeld alongside Spike Dykes and Shea Walker, and it is good to have you along for what should be a fun night of football here in College Station. And Coach, obviously the buzz is about Dennis Franchione in his first game. You've been there, you've done that. What's going through the man's mind right now?
Well, you got to make sure you got everything done. You got to get all your I's dotted, all your T's crossed. You got a new staff with a new football team at a new school and playing a new opponent. So, everything's got to work. It's important to get off to a good start.
All right, Shea Walker, you've been a lot of these openers over the years. Have you ever seen, first of all, the atmosphere as electric as it is right now? And question number two is, what changes you look for from 02 to 03?
Well, Kevin, to answer the first question, no, I haven't, because this place is absolutely buzzing and people have been very excited about the Franchione era to get kicked off, and we're going to start it here tonight. If you look talk about the differences, look to the defense. You're going to see the vaunted A&M wrecking crew who's been running a 3-4 defense for the last 20 years. They're going to now run the 4-3 defense. But, hey, Aggie fans, don't worry. Coach Franchione says Coach Torbush doesn't start blitzing until he walks off the bus, so look for them to continue to bring a lot of pressure.
Yeah, we've been doing football games for a long time. I've never come to the stadium not knowing, at least this late, who was going to be the starting quarterback. You don't know, we don't know, and I'm not sure exactly who knows right now, but it's a good problem for Dennis Franchione. We're all going to find out together here in just a couple minutes.
Great problem. You got Reggie McNeil, who is a rolling ball of butcher knives. He can get away and go the whole distance anytime. And then you've got the Mississippi River, old Steady Dustin Long. And I tell you, either one of those guys are great football players. And so I think the field generalship is in good hands.
And for a junior sophomore, these two guys have handled this very, very well. Wouldn't you agree?
Absolutely. Both of those kids are so mature, and the team respects both of them. And that's really critical if you're going to talk about the quarterback position. And I like Franchione's answer as to who is going to be a starting quarterback. Earlier this week he said, my starting quarterback is going to be Dustin McNeil. So there you have it.
All right. Well, of course, if you've ever been to a game here in Aggieland, you know that it is something special. And that was a big reason why Dennis Franchione came here.
I've been in some great stadiums, and to see that it was voted maybe the number one stadium in all of college football has really heightened my excitement to coach my first game there and to coach there at A&M, and the 12th man and all the things that go with that that make that stadium so good, and the energy and the excitement that we have going into this season with it being a little bit new for everyone. Certainly August 30th will be an exciting night for them.
For the first time in 2003, this welcome sight as Aggie fans around the country looking forward to this one. That is true. Tell you a little bit about Arkansas State. They come in a team that went just 2-9 2 years ago. Steve Robinson. A year ago, he really turned that program around, became the winningest first-year coach in Arkansas State history. But this night, really about Texas A&M first-year head coach Dennis Franchione. He is standing by with Randy McEvoy. Randy Mac.
Thanks, Kevin. 5 pages in the media guide lay out the foundation for this program. It's called the Fran Plan. It's a recipe for success that's worked for Dennis Franchione. Have you had a chance to soak in this game day atmosphere here in Aggie?
Well, a little bit, but probably not enough, but I'm sure I will.
You talk about being a balanced attack offensively with quarterback. Any indication who you might go with?
As soon as we run out there for that first play, you'll know.
Well done. Dennis Franchione ready to open up a new era here at Texas A&M. Kevin, back to you.
All right. Thank you very much. So you got it, folks. When we find out, you will find out. We'll all find out together. We've got college football coming up. The 2003 season just moments away from kicking off. Arkansas State and Texas A&M from Kyle Field when we come back.
All over America, people are throwing out their cable boxes and switching to DirecTV. That's because right now when you call this toll-free number, you can get a free two-room DirecTV system with professional installation. You heard right. Get a DirecTV system with standard professional installation, a $250 value when you call Prime TV now. With cable, you can pay upwards of $45 or more each and every month for basic channels and still don't always get your favorites. Like do-it-yourself and food channels. If you're lucky, maybe your local cable company will offer them. But with DirecTV service, they're already here, including the best DirecTV programming. With access to over 225 available channels, featuring the best premium movie channels like HBO and Cinemax, Showtime, even Stars, Sports Pack, and favorites like NFL Sunday Ticket, with your choice of nearly every NFL game on Sundays throughout the regular season. Family programming, music choice, and DirecTV pay-per-view movies and events. Plus, you get access to your top local channels, all at a price that's a whole lot less than cable. With DirecTV service, you get digital quality pictures that make you feel like you're right in the middle of the action, and digital quality sound featuring state-of-the-art DVD quality. And now get 4 months free of DirecTV's best programming package, Total Choice Premier with local channels. That's right, you get over 225 channels free for 4 months. When you call now.
Hey, knock it off up there.
Sorry. Call 1-800-906-9155 for your new DirecTV system. Just pick up the phone and call 1-800-906-9155 for your DirecTV system now. Offer ends September 30th, 2003.
Well, Terrence Dunbar brings it out for Arkansas State out across the 30-yard line. It's a good field position for Arkansas State as they go on offense first to start in this ball game. And they're led by Elliot Jacobs as we welcome you back to Kyle Field in College Station. The 6'2", 225-pound junior. You talk to the coaching staff and they mention the word poise more than any other thing. And he has plenty of it and he's probably going to need it tonight as he brings his team out. Formation, Antonio Warren, the setback. Oren O'Neal is the fullback. Nothing there. Huge penetration up front. Johnny Jolly leading the way.
What a play.
Let's get your starting lineups for you. Elliot Jacobs, the junior from El Dorado, Arkansas. You see the numbers in his career, over 2,300 yards, 12 touchdowns. He's thrown four picks. Warren and O'Neal will be in the backfield. The wideouts, Walker Brooks, Gary Vincent, and Mike Cox, the other wide receivers. There you see the guys up front as Kamini Jones leads the way, the preseason all-conference player, but he was beaten badly that time by Johnny Jolly. Playing in his first game out of Forney, Texas, there for another loss.
Okay, we'll take a nice look here. You see Warren trying to make the cutback and just absolutely nothing doing. That's a big bulldog kind of tackle right there by David Ross, and that's got these A&M fans fired up.
Great charge out of that second, out of that front four, I'll tell you that.
There they are, Ross, Jolly, Patrick, and Linus Smith on the edge. McDaniel, Morris, and Manning the backers, and there you see the DBs. Weston and Jones on the corners. Appel and Jackson are the safeties. On third down, back up the middle, maybe back to the original line of scrimmage after the 31-yard line, but just not much there as Jared Morris made the stop, the senior from Brownwood.
That's an early season Third down and about 14 to try to convert. Run a little bit of draw play right up the middle, but Jared Morris having none of it. The middle linebacker, who's a good run stuffer, shows why right there. Look at the leverage as he keeps those legs driving, not allowing Warren to power up and get more yards.
Jared Morris will punt it away. Jason Carter back deep for Texas A&M. Low liner. Carter with room, but hit immediately and brought down.
Great coverage by the kicking team.
Jonathan Burke, coach, down there on the coverage, and Lathor Wood to Jason Carter.
Coach, take a look at this. This is a little bit of 7-on-7. Number 7 right there, right on Jason Carter. Boy, you talk about a shot.
Oh, I'm telling you, a shot. That's great coverage.
That's how you get down and cover them things, isn't it?
Good punt. You know, that first punt's always important every year.
Well, you saw on the snap. The snap was a little bit low, but the punter did a nice job of handling it. Got it off well. The coverage team did a nice job of stopping them for no gain.
And the answer to your question, Reggie McNeil, the starting quarterback. As Derek Farmer in at the I-back. First down play action, McNeil being pressured and brought down. Sacked on the first play of the game back at the 30-yard line as we set the starting lineups for you. Reggie McNeil getting the start at quarterback. The sophomore from Lufkin, Texas, made one start a year ago. Came off the bench in that 30-26 win over Oklahoma. Keith Joseph and Derek Farmer when they go with the fullback in the backfield. Murphy, Schuster, the tight end, Thomas, and Tim Van Zandt, the flanker. The big guys up front, and they are big.
And 6, good.
7, 3, 10 for Alan Ruber on that strong tackle. Now the conventional eye set. Here's Farmer hit in the backfield. You knew Arkansas State, the defense, was going to come to play, and Chris Littleton, a huge hitter, a sophomore from Osceola, Arkansas, was there to make the stop.
Chris Littleton doing a great job of coming off the corner blitz. He comes right up, and he just absolutely lays the wood right there to Derek Farmer, knocking him back for a loss. That, I tell you, that's an aggressive style defense. When you're coming into a hostile environment and you kind of got on your heels, you went three and out, you really want to try to push the other team to a three and out. Arkansas State so far doing a good job.
Well, Jack Curtis told me he's a big hitter. Sometimes he doesn't always wrap up, but he is a big hitter, and he'll let you know he's there. That's what happened right there. Here's a big third down, McNeil. Won't get to the first down. An outstanding defensive stand for Arkansas State to open this game.
Those two tackles, Bradley and Williams, are good players.
Well, you're not talking. Good players.
Yeah. Zach Grigsby there to make the stop there. So it's punt time. And one of the best in the country in to do the honors.
This is always a hold-your-breath play right here now, first time of the year.
That's Jacob Young in to punt it away.
Cody Skates is out right now. He had a hernia earlier in camp, so he is out for this game. Jacob Young, the walk-on, is punting in his place.
Good snap.
And he had the eight of the win, and it's back to the four-yard line. And back out to the 20-yard line. That's a nice job of making something out of nothing by Mike Cox, the punt returner, who was all the way back inside his five, but yet brings it out to the 20-yard line. And all things considered, good field position for the Indians of Arkansas State.
Coach, you talk about holding your breath on that punt. When you see a guy as a freshman being your punt returner going back and fielding that ball inside the five-yard line in a hostile environment, what do you think about that?
He really held your breath. He was running for his life. He wasn't running for yards.
He wanted a good spot on the bench when he got off the field. If he didn't get out there, he wouldn't have had one.
First down at 10, Elliott Jacobs calling the signals. A left-hander throws this one out in the flat and complete. Out to the 22-yard line, and it's Jerome Stegall with the catch. Guy who made 12 catches a year ago, converted running back. He hauls that one in. He's a junior from Wynn, Arkansas.
You know, this Arkansas State line, they average 318 pounds. They're big.
Some big fellas up front.
Yeah, 318 is big from tackle to tackle.
Biggest right in the middle, Tab Slaughter at 332 pounds. As a gain of four, second down six. Here's Warren, nothing doing again. Ooh. Are they there to meet the handoff as soon as it's handed off? The A&M defense up to the task so far. Johnny Jolly was the first man, but got plenty of help as Johnny Jolly was there to make the stop.
Well, just when Arkansas State looked like they might have a little bit going on second down, they had a short second down field, but Johnny Jolly doing a nice job of shedding off that offensive line. And the surest thing about that play was the way that he made the tackle. He wasn't in there arm tackling. He ended up lining up the headgear right on the numbers and dropping for a loss.
Third down and eight. Already the third play for negative yardage for Arkansas State. Complete the war. The pursuit is there for the second time in as many possessions. Arkansas State will punt the football away.
Good quickness on the defense right there. That's what you call going to the football.
Marcus Jasmine is doing that.
Great play out of these guys right here.
Yeah, but I tell you, I like the way Byron Jones forced that play, Coach, coming up from that cornerback position. He had the wide receiver blocking on it, but he came in there and had enough momentum to take the legs out from the runner, the inside pursuit, and ended up getting. That's just how you want to play defense on that screen pass.
Jason Carter back deep. Jared Little will punt it away again. It's a fourth down and five. Carter again.
Oh, man. That's
out to the 38-yard line. So a timeout of the field. We'll take it with them with 8:03 to go in College Station, a scoreless first quarter.
Hey, I know you're frustrated with slow dial-up internet. And if you think you can't get high-speed internet, think again. Now there's a new high-speed internet solution by Satellite. And you can get it right now. DirectWay is the high-speed internet that works anywhere in the continental U.S., just as long as you have a clear view of the sun. Interested? Thought so. Now grab your remote, flip to channel 227, and find out about the new high-speed internet option available right now. Channel 227. I'll meet you there.
Setanta Sport presents the English national soccer team in the Euro 2004 qualifying campaign. Don't miss the action live on pay-per-view.
Sunday.
Scoreless game, so you want to be an official. That umpire's got to be tough.
Well, you want to take a look. Here he is right here, Kevin. And Reggie's going to take the ball. He's going to scramble up, come around. And as he starts to go back to his right in the field, referee O'Hara is going to get this run right over the top of it by Corey Williams. At 6'4", 303 pounds. You're going to see it right here on the right side of your screen. Here we go. Boom! That's what you call making your pay right there now.
It's a tough occupation. You know, those officials need a little of that, though. They really do. Yeah. They need humility.
Yeah, it never hurt my feelings to see him get bumped around a little bit. Just don't hurt him.
Keith Joseph, the up man. That's Courtney Lewis into the tailback and mishandling of the snap. Reggie McNeil gets right back on the football.
You know, Kevin, this defensive football team's got eight senior starters. Good football team.
Absolutely. They brought back, really, in the heart of it, too, Coach, is that interior of that defensive line between Bradley and Williams. You got a couple of great athletes that can really play.
These are real great pro prospects. There's no doubt about it. They're both highly rated and good players.
Yeah, John Bradley and Corey Williams, the two inside tackles on this front four for Arkansas State. McNeil wanted to throw quickly. Woo! Throws downfield, intercepted and dropped.
Did you see the 99 on that play?
Jonathan Burke had the football and couldn't hold on. Guy that had five picks a year ago just dropped number one of 2003.
And that Corey Williams chased him down, I tell you.
Corey Williams is right on Reggie McNeil. You hear about all the flash and dash about McNeil, but I tell you what, Corey Williams, a big 6'4", 303-pounder, was right on him.
Hey, those two guys are good now. It's going to be hard.
Yeah, and we're talking about a really young, relatively inexperienced offensive line for Texas A&M going against some really good two techniques right now. It's going to be a long ball game for these guys.
That's Joseph in motion. On the delay. Farmer again. The defense is there to meet him as soon as he gets the football. Zach Grigsby playing in his neck of the woods. He's a senior from Converse Judson in the San Antonio area. And you know when they come out of Converse Judson, they know how to play football. That's the case for that young man.
They know how to play it and play it at a high level. I believe Zach was on a state championship team at Converse, Judson.
I tell you, this defensive unit for Arkansas State is good. They've got great, good size, good speed, and lots of experience.
Well, their lateral pursuit. You're watching them here, Coach, and you got to be impressed with the way that they're running and flying to the football, and they're really not getting any creases or anything open for that A&M offense yet.
Plus, say they run a 4-2 defense, and that means there's five other guys, and they put them everywhere. And
Jacob Young's punt goes into the end zone, so it'll come out to the 20 again. What has been a defensive-dominated first quarter. Scoreless right now with 6:32 to go. So far, it's been all about the defense. Texas A&M hasn't been able to do anything with the back with the football, nor has Arkansas State.
The San Antonio Spurs are NBA champions once again.
Call for three. Yes!
Celebrate their amazing victory with Sports Illustrated's Thrill Pack, featuring the official NBA Finals 2003 home video on your choice of DVD or VHS. Plus, the Sports Illustrated hardbound commemorative. This individually numbered classic gives an inside look at the Spurs' thrilling championship run. Both are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, giving you 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. This Spurs long sleeve champions t-shirt is also free when you use your credit card. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it's steel gray, lightweight, and fit for a champion. Call now. You'll get all three great Spurs collectibles free. This championship package is available exclusively for the number one team in the NBA from the number one magazine in sports, Sports Illustrated. Call now.
We're going to be back to College Station. Third possession of the game for Arkansas State. So far, it's been three and out and three and out. That has been a theme in this ball game. There's Antonio Warren around the corner and out to the 30-yard line. And by far, the most impressive offensive play of the night for Arkansas State. He's near a first down and may have it.
Tight end Mike Brooks made a heck of a block then, I tell you. That's a good running, good play, good first down play.
Well, Steve Roberts went, ASU went 2-9 in 01. 6-7 was the turnaround when he came in 02 in his first season. He was at Northwestern State in Natchitoches, Louisiana before heading to Jonesboro, Arkansas. He did an outstanding job with this program. It was enough for the first down for Warren. A gain of 10 on that play. Going up top and some bumping downfield. It's good coverage by Byron Jones. He was there to knock the would-be receiver Chuck Walker off his pins and out of the route and out of bounds. Second down and 10 coming up. Arkansas State, a team picked fourth in the Sun Belt. North Texas, New Mexico State, and Middle Tennessee picked to finish ahead of them.
Well, they're doing a good job, Kevin, and what they've got to do, hang in there and be patient and give everything a chance to work, and they're doing a good job of that so far.
They're going to call a timeout. Yeah, you'll see a little bit of leadership right there by Elliott Jacobs.
And again, I say what we talked about earlier was the fact that when you talk with this coaching staff about Elliott Jacobs, the first word that comes out of their mouth is poise. He's like a coach on the field, and he's going to need to be that way tonight, that is for sure. Arkansas State and A&M scoreless in the first quarter.
Raise the flag, yes, you're ready for a little more poncho. Raise the flag, yes, you're ready for a little more poncho.
Hip-a. Poncho's Piping Hot Sopapillas and Honey are free every day. Poncho's, fresh handmade Mexican food, great prices and family fun. Still hungry?
Raise the flag, you're ready for a little more poncho Mexican buffet.
Texas is reloaded and eyeing that elusive title. The lethal duo of Benson.
Watson and Williams powers the Longhorns against New Mexico State. Tonight at 6 on Fox Sports Net. Mike Sweeney and the Royals are in a battle for the AL Central crown as they take on A-Rod and the Rangers. Series begins Monday on Fox Sports Net.
The traditions of Texas A&M football here in the first quarter, 6:01 to play. Let's go down to Randy McAvoy.
Yeah, thanks, Kevin. Aggie spirit, you know it when you feel it, and when you feel it most. Normally on that Friday night before a home game, they call it yell practice, and what a turnout last night they had. The purpose of any yell practice, to build enthusiasm, get the 12th man ready for football. Coach Fran helped get it that way last night.
I can see why CNN has not voted this the number one college football stadium in America because of you.
Kyle Fielden right there chiming in on the spirit of Aggie Land was Coach Fran and his wife Kim. Guys, he really embraced the Aggie tradition since day one and when he was hired here at Texas A&M, and it showed last night.
All right, Randy. So far, he has seen his offense go against a very good Arkansas State defense here in this first half of a first quarter in his opener. Career record of 155-73-2, and that is in the high rent district among active coaches. That's for sure. We'll show you exactly how high rent coming up just a little bit later on. Jacob straight drop to throw on third down, looking for a man. Has his man at the 40-yard line, but it's going to be short of a first down as Cox was able to lay out there to pull it in, but still short of the first down. Mike Cox, leading returning receiver on this team, senior from Red Bluff, California. It's going to be fourth and about a foot.
Nice job about laying out and catching that ball right there. And Jacobs threw a dart because Cox was well covered by Byron Jones, and he threw it to the only place where Cox could catch it, and Jones couldn't get a fingertip on it, but it still left them about a half a yard short, and they're going to tee up the punt team and play a little battle of field position right now.
And Jared Little will be the man to punt it away, and they'll rely on that defense right now. Jason Carter is back deep. Off the side of his foot for a short punt.
Good quick, good one.
Down to the 43-yard line. So
that's not the battle of field position that you're looking for right there. When you make the play, that's kind of like, lining up on the second shot in the fairway on a par five, and you go ahead and hit that three-wood into the water in the front and say, why didn't I just lay it up?
You know, Arkansas State coaches were talking about, we don't know exactly what to prepare for when we go against this A&M team. It's going to be a very diverse offense. They've been looking at Alabama film all week long, so here's an idea.
Being a multiple offense and defense, that helps us define which direction to take with the vision of our offense and defense in putting our best players in position to make plays. And that's basically what we've always been about offensively and now defensively, is multiplicity that gives you flexibility to play to the strengths of your football team.
Oh, McNeil that time overshot the intended receiver, and he had the man open, but just a little bit too tall for Jamal Taylor to be able to pull that one in. Is Jamar an outstanding receiver, but that one a little too high.
Well, Reggie rolling out to his left on a design rollout, and that's really a great idea Les Caning has, is get your athlete out on the corner, give him the run pass option. McNeil just had a little bit too much juice on that ball, and it sailed over the head of Jamar Taylor, but certainly he got him out there where he can run or throw it. He's going to be very dangerous.
For second down, 10. Right up the gut, Farmer. Gain of 4, gain of 5 yards, and what looked like was a big hole, closed in a hurry. And again, Casey Venters was there to make the stop, also got some help from the free safety, Alex Peoples. And in this scheme for Arkansas State, they really rely on their free safety against the run, and he was there up to the task. And now another big third down situation for Texas A&M as it's third down and 5.
This is a big play. And
got Jason Carter, the A-back, the guy that had a huge spring, and they're going to try to use a lot, lined up in this A-back position right there.
4 wide outs in effect. This one complete. Jamar Taylor has the first down to the 40-yard line.
Great move by Jamar Taylor.
Wasn't what he did before he got the football, but what he did after.
Hey, I correct myself here. That's Joseph, Keith Joseph, the fullback, lining up right there, number four, and he just lays a whale of a block on the cornerback. Jamar doing an outstanding job of making people miss and picking up a first down. Nice little luxury that you can have when you got a guy that's about 258 pounds running out there throwing blocks like that.
Yeah. Jamar says, let's keep it rolling. First down of the night for Texas A&M. Here's Farmer. Farmer right back to the line of scrimmage. John Bradley and Corey Williams kind of mucking things up there in the middle, and linebackers in to finish it off as Les Eccles will get credited for the tackle.
Kevin, a lot of the talk coming into this ball game for A&M coming out of Tua Days was the offensive line and the inexperience that they have in the offensive line. Jamie Hightower unfortunately developed an infection. He's out. He's got redshirt freshman Alex Coetzer starting in his place. Jeff Hangartner is the junior out of New Braunfels High School, but he's about the most experienced guy and best player that they have on that offensive front, so they're fairly thin and fairly young.
And they're playing against some of the best in the country.
McNeil, open man. The fullback, Keith Joseph, coming out of the backfield, makes the catch, and he's got great hands. Give you an idea, he's a running back that ran it six times last year, but caught it 13.
He's lined up in the back, Kevin. As you said, the offensive line doing a great job of giving Reggie enough time to look down the field and find Keith Joseph, who came all the way out of the back. But he was a top receiver coming out of the backfield for A&M last season.
And he's got it down to the 14-yard line. First down and 10. Joseph from Houston Lamar High School. Courtney Lewis in the backfield along with Reggie McNeil. McNeil making things happen and down to the 11-yard line, and about as exciting a 3-yard gain as you will ever see.
Ran 22 yards to make 3 yards.
Well, give Arkansas defensive front a lot of credit as they're all sliding over well. They're taking away the running lane, and it's very difficult to make stuff happen when you've got a team that pursues that well and runs that well laterally as Arkansas State's defense is doing. And Reggie, really nowhere to go with that football.
For second down and 7. A&M looking to get in the end zone for the first time tonight. Time ticking away here in the first quarter. Courtney Lewis, and there's whistle to play dead, some movement up front.
But Courtney Lewis is really impressed, Coach.
Delay a game on the offense, 5 yards. Repeat the down.
Tom Oller is our referee.
And others. Courtney Lewis has really come on and shown a lot at the last spring. He redshirted out of Houston Madison on that Madison team with Vincent Young.
Yep.
And he's done a lot. There's the officials tonight. You know any of those, Coach?
Yes, I do.
Any of them on your Christmas card list?
Yeah, you know, the officials are great guys. That's a heck of a fraternity.
McNeil being pressured. And he'll go down back at the 27-yard line. Vince, Zach Grigsby, I beg your pardon, there again.
Kevin, Zach Grigsby is the one who's going to get credit for that tackle, but let's talk about who makes it. Number 30, Chris Littleton, coming up from his safety position. You're going to see him over here as he comes up and he puts the pursuit on right there around Reggie's knees, and then there's Zach with a lot of hustle, good lateral pursuit, bringing him down. But that's the second time now we've seen Arkansas State come on that corner blitz and try to get in and bring that safety up, and they've been successful both times with it.
Well, now you're looking here on third down. 12 to go for the first down. You got to get it inside the 5-yard line, the 4-yard line, the line to make. On third down, gunning this one incomplete. So now it's field goal time. Ty Pegram, 42 yards out. It'll be a long field goal. His longest is 43, but maybe not so soon because a timeout called on the field as they want to talk this one over.
Well, we got triple O's on the clock right now, so it looks like the first quarter's...
Beg your pardon, we ran out of time.
I'll tell you what, Kevin, there's a lot of wind in this stadium tonight. We look across the top of the field and see the way the flags are blowing. Pegram now is going to have to take this attempt into the wind.
So the second quarter right around the corner and a scoreless first. 15 minutes in the books, nothing decided yet.
Weeknights, the biggest stars are on the best damn sports show, period.
Yeah! Fire and living color.
Please welcome Samuel.
It's entertainment.
Mike Tyson.
Am I going to say this? Like the best damn sports show?
Yeah! Weeknights.
It's happening again. And it's happening now on pay-per-view.
It's coming for us.
With special bonus footage not seen in theaters.
It's not over yet.
We have to fight this thing.
Stay at home, press a button, order a movie, and there are no late fees. Final Destination 2.
I hope you're ready for this.
Order it now on DirecTV Pay-Per-View.
This time, it's going to be different.
I'll beat him again.
This is what I want.
Your hands can't hit what your eyes can't see.
Shane, better be ready.
De La Hoya, Mosley 2, Redemption. Saturday, September 13th, live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View. Don't miss Redemption, live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View, Channel 101.
Believe me, Shane, I will get you.
You're still the same to me.
So Todd Pegram has a career long of 43 yards, and he'll try it here from 42. 43-yarder coming last year against Virginia Tech. This one into a stiff breeze out of the south. And he's good.
That's a good kick. All that wind, all that heat, I'm telling you.
So on the first play of the second quarter, Texas A&M gets on the board for the first time in 2003. A 42-yard field goal by Todd Pegram. The Aggies lead it 3-0.
Coach Todd Pegram's really coming on. He's out of Plano High School, and last year he struggled a little bit as a freshman. I think he went 12 for 21 and had a little bit of trouble making some extra points and stuff. But Coach Fran, going through two a days, and you know this as a coach. Kids coming in a year of maturity, a year of learning, a year of handling the expectation, of playing in front of a crowd. It's a big difference. It's a change for a lot of kids, and took him about a year to get doing that, and so far he's representing himself pretty well, hitting that 42-yarder.
That's a heck of a way to start it, too, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Another big difference, going to the 4-3 defense for the first time in a decade and a half, and it is Francione talked about the new look on D.
Our defense is a little young in places. I don't think we have a star-studded person necessarily at this point in time, but we have a group, and team defense is always the best, and I think those guys are very conscientious of that.
Well, the defense being led by that man, Carl Torbush, the former minor league baseball player, still plays in an over 25 league.
Yeah, plus he's a former head coach at North Carolina.
Absolutely. And over at Louisiana Tech.
He's been around a block or two. Yeah.
And he's all business, too, isn't he? The guy, and that's how you want your D coordinator to be. Have that serious demeanor, that kind of ticked off look on your face.
Yeah.
Coach Torbush certainly delivers.
So here's the kick. Good run back out to the 30-yard line as Terrence Dunbar brings it back and a nice return. Pretty good field position for Arkansas State as they trail it 3-0.
That's the old flying wedge kickoff return. And you see those big bulls up front there, and they knocked a hole in there.
Well, special teams is all about attitude. It's not about ability.
That's right.
I mean, it's as much as you want to be out there and go out there and hit somebody and run through them, and that's what special teams is.
You know, Shay, so many games are won and lost special teams early in the season. It's important.
It's just so hard to practice them, though, until you get to live game. The ball when you get to, they should count an awful lot.
Elliot Jacobs throwing this one incomplete.
Oh, great coverage.
Well, wow. You're not kidding. It was step for step. Jonte Poole
LaJonte, nice to see him back in the lineup. A young man who had a tough 0-2, but he is back.
That's a big thing about corners, Kevin. They got to have short memories. Yeah, you don't. You just. You. It's almost play to play to be effective. If you're going to be a cornerback, you got to have thick skin, no ears, and a short memory, and also some pretty good athletic ability to go along with that.
Antonio Warren.
Oh, good play by Jared Marsh. Good stop. He plugged up the hole. Nice play. Hey, Jared Marsh is a good, big, strong inside linebacker. He's done a heck of a job.
Aggies active leader in tackles, 163, and you put a couple more on the board tonight.
Well, how about that fighting off the block there? You got a guy all on you and up around your shoulders and having enough strength to set him and then still put a good shoulder-level stick on the running back. That's pretty impressive out there by Jared Marsh.
Yes, it is.
Third down, 7. Quick pass, caught.
Where'd he come from?
The first down. As Cox was there to make
the
catch. Sean Weston there to knock him off his feet, but not before Mike Cox is there to pick up the first down and move the chains.
Kevin, you talk about the poise. Look at L.A. Jacobs. He sees the pressure coming, but he delivers a perfect ball. He doesn't put too much on it, but he throws a perfect ball right there to Cox. Cox is able to catch it without too much fanfare and nothing going on around him and turn it up and pick up the first down. But that's a really good throw by L.A. Jacobs right there.
Movement.
Johnny Jolly saying, hey, they drew me off. Looks like that's the way the call is going to go. Because
he doesn't get a vote. That man does.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense, 5 yards, well, still first down.
He agreed with Johnny Jolly.
He voted his proxy.
That's right.
Well, you saw Johnny, he was down in the three-point stance, and that right leg came up, but he brought it back just fast enough, and that's the referee saw that the left tackle had pulled him off sides there.
So first down and 15. Right in the backfield, nothing doing. Jared Morris. He was coming all the way and made the stop.
Jared Marsh is one heck of a good football player this year. He gets better every time I see him. He was good last year, but man, he is outstanding so far.
Real rough and tumble kind of guy.
Yeah,
you wouldn't want to meet up with him in a dark alley unless he was on your side.
Yeah, that's right. Plus, I'm going to tell you this: he got some guns, doesn't he?
There's a loss of a yard. Second down and 16. Penalty marker down.
But maybe Arkansas State losing a little composure here. It's another penalty. Will take them back 5 more.
Prior to the snap, false start.
You know, one thing we haven't mentioned about this, little noise.
Yes, there is.
And Steve Roberts had them bring in noise all week long during practices, but I don't think there's any way you could simulate this.
You can't get 80,000 noises in there.
As much as you turn up those speakers at the practice field, Coach, I'm sure you guys did it at Tech. We did it here at A&M, and there's just no way you can duplicate the energy, the excitement, the intensity, and then you throw all this noise on top of it. It's just you can't duplicate it until you go through it.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
Second down, 21 to go for the first down. Hand it off up the middle, and it'll be third down and a mile and a half for the first down.
Kevin, they're doing what they got to do, though. They're not taking any big, bad chances. They're not gambling, and they're going to just go play a little consistent, play ball control, punt it down there.
One of the things about the Aggies that you're going to notice this year in this defensive scheme, look at all the guys flying to the football. Now, you're going to have 5, 6, 7, 8 maroon hats around that tackle every single play. We saw it on the last play. That's what got the fans all jacked up and loud, forced the delay of gameplay, and then you see about 5, 6, 7, 8 of them again running around the football. But there's a lot of intensity on that defensive side.
They were flying to the football, and Brian Patrick landed first. Third down. 19 to go for the first. Jacobs with time, throws.
Caught
for the first down.
He caught that ball.
Stegall pulled it out after I thought I was going to say it was...
Sean Weston came over the top, Kevin, of the cornerback. He made an outstanding play on the football. Just wasn't able to bring it in and tipped it up, and that was a very, very heady play by Jerome Stegall.
They move the sticks out of the 41-yard line.
Well, that's great concentration, keeping your eye on the ball as you're falling down, the ball falling short of you and able to catch it before it hits the turf.
Heads up,
starting to catch up there. And great defense. The defense was there, just didn't secure the ball.
First down and 10. Crowd gets into it and right up the middle, and again, not much there. And Jared Morris once again there to make the tackle.
Jared Morris is something else. Watch him on this play. He just continues to make the big play. Big, strong, great middle linebacker.
He's going to be in double digits tonight, guys.
There he is right there. And what a player.
Gained about a foot. We call it second down and 9.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here comes the pressure. Throw incomplete. Threw it behind the intended receiver, Chuck Walker. But the heat was coming again. I think Johnny Jolly was coming through there. And he had some friends on the way as well. David Ross was right back there as well.
Kevin, one of the things about this Arkansas State offense is they're not real flashy. They're not down the field going to bomb it and run up a lot of points, but they go running back by committee. They got four or five guys that we're going to see in the tailback position tonight. All of them are going to play, but they just try to ball control, stay in the ball game, keep the score close if you can, try to win it in the end, and right now they're doing a pretty good job of hanging on to football.
Last year they won time of possession in all but two games. They like to control it, that's for sure. This one's complete. Mike Cox again. Finally wrestled down by Byron Jones, but a gain of 13 yards. And once again, Arkansas State with another first down.
Look at the protection. Look at the protection on this play, and that's why that he's able to throw the football. There's nobody's there. Look at that cup in there.
And, nice job of stepping up and finding Mike Cox. Now, Mike Cox got hurt last year, but I tell you what, had 100 yards against Virginia Tech receiving, so this guy certainly knows how to play in a big-time environment. He's showing it right now.
There's a hole down to the 10-yard line.
Look like a dump truck.
Shamar Bracey, and he's built like one, too. Coach, 6'2", 225 pounds, and he is the fastest of the five tailbacks on the depth chart.
Well, you talk about the fastest, Kevin. He has been clocked at a 4.3 in the 40, and he's also the high school. He's an Arkansas State high school state champion, 100 and 200 meters. He looks like he's running with a little bit of purpose there, doesn't it?
He got some body weight.
Transfer from Coffeyville Junior College. Down to the 10-yard line. They could still get a first down. They try to send him wide. Got the corner down to the 5, to the 4, to the 3-yard line.
That's a good play call.
Great play call, getting your fastest back out on the corner like that. And I'm telling you, when you go as big as he does, as Kevin was mentioning, the guy's about 225 pounds, and to get him out on the corner now, and it's hard. You say, that guy can't move out. He can't beat me to the corner, but you know what? He's got enough wheels. He does it and turns it upfield, picks up some big yards down there in the red zone.
That is a big play.
And Shea said a 4-3, 8-40 time. Now it is second down. Again, a first down can be gained inside the 1-yard line. Down to the 2-yard line goes Shamar Bracey.
Good pursuit right there by the A&M front four. Now they were flat coming after Arkansas State and in the backfield. And Shamar Bracey, fortunate for Arkansas State, was running to the left side there, because had he not been, he'd have been drugged down for about a 2-yard loss.
I'm really impressed with the pursuit of the Aggies. They really can pursue the football good. They're big and they're strong and they're fast.
They're going to have to be strong up front here, because it's a third down and less than a yard to go for the first down, but the ball is sitting on the 2-yard line. Crowd getting into it. They drop the football.
You can thank the crowd for that fumble.
You got that right, because Orin O'Neill fell on it, and almost a disaster for Arkansas State, as they were in a position where
really weren't going to be able to come away with any points if they obviously if they had turned it over there. Archie McDaniel was there to make the stop.
They just got a little bit of confusion there on the snap. Didn't field it cleanly. And Archie McDaniel from Bay City and Jackson Appel coming up there laying some heavy hits. Stopping Warren O'Neill from picking up any yards. Actually dropped it for about a 2.5 yard loss.
Eric Niehaus, 10 of 22 in the field goal department a year ago from the left hash. And he ties it at 3. What an impressive drive by Arkansas State as they come right back to tie the football game at 3 apiece. Aggies with
the Coach Fran era is underway, and there's no better way to follow it than Aggie Ultimate Access. AUA gives you daily coverage from inside the program. Our cameras have rolled at team building events, on Fran when he passed out the Aggie ring, and AUA was even on hand when the Aggies moved into their new home, the Bright Football Complex. Plus, we have press conferences, practice reports, exclusive interviews, scouting reports, and game recap. Aggie Ultimate Access, your all-access pass to Aggie Athletics.
Are you ready for football? Check out the season's hottest ticket from DirecTV. When you subscribe to the NFL Sunday Ticket exclusively from DirecTV, you will get 4 free months of Total Choice Premier with local channels. Act now on this incredible deal, and you will also get a 4-room DirecTV system, including standard installation, for free. Call now, 1-800-505-6988. See the games you want to see with a choice of nearly every NFL game on Sundays only from DirecTV. You will also get the best DirecTV programming package, the Total Choice Premier with local channels, including family and kids programming, plus over 30 premium channels from HBO, Starz, Showtime, Cinemax, and Sports Pack. If you call now, you'll get up to 4 rooms professionally installed in your home free. This incredible offer will not last long, so what are you waiting for? Sign up for DirecTV NFL Sunday Ticket and get 4 free months of Total Choice Premier. If that's not enough, you'll also get a 4-room DirecTV system, including standard installation, for free. Call toll-free 1-800-505-6988. That's 1-800-505-6988. One call, we install.
We're tied in Aggieland with 7:26 to play. First half, Terrence Murphy back deep along with Jamar Taylor. This will be Murphy, 2 yards deep in the end zone. Murphy has some room. A 59-yard run back.
Special teams.
Talk about it. This boy has got some wheels, too. Now, Terrence Murphy, starting wide receiver. Nice job of feeling in the vision that he has. Look at all the open field moves he's throwing. Now, he's throwing those moves, Coach, at full speed, and that's not easy to do. No, makes the kicker miss. He almost spun that tackle. He spins out of that tackle. He might have taken that one to the house. So, outstanding return given Dustin Long as he comes into the ball game. Excellent starting field position.
The junior from Port Neches, Texas, taking his first snaps of 2003. Stands tall in the pocket. Looking up top, has a man, Taylor. A gain of 21 yards.
That's the hardest pass in football. The post corner.
He's running that post corner, Coach.
Yeah.
And he's running that, right against that two deeps coverage right there. And boy, there's a real soft belly out there in the corner. Dustin Long doing a nice job of getting enough air underneath the ball to get over the cornerback's head and let it splash down before the safety can make a play. That's good execution by Long and Taylor.
Leandro Adams was coming over, but not in time. You see the numbers from a year ago, and those are record-setting numbers for Dustin Long. Handed off, and man, big hit at the line of scrimmage on Derek Farmer.
Tokes made a great tackle. 15, the linebacker. Excellent tackle.
He did. He played a little wood, didn't he? Linebackers for both teams tonight are.
What this guy right here? Yeah, he is one kind of good linebacker, I'm telling you, Shane.
5'10", 225 pounds. Built like a fire plug.
Got a lot of hustle in him.
Stone Mountain, Georgia, the junior.
You ought to be good from Stone Mountain.
Stone a few players. There you go.
So that's a gain of 3, second down and 7. On the delay, Farmer. Brought down, sure tackle, down to the 15-yard line is Alex Peoples. Talking with the defensive coordinator, Jack Curtis, he said Alex Peoples is the best tackler he has ever been around, and he showed it right there. Not about a big hit,
but about a guy that will actually bring somebody down.
Well, I tell you what, if he doesn't make this play right here, though, Farmer's eyes were obviously pointed out there to the left. He was trying to make that cutback. He slowed down just a hair to make that cutback to the left, and when he did, Alex Peoples closed on him and brought him down just short of the first down.
Third down and four. Good protection. Into the end zone and off the fingertips. Just a little too tall.
Good mobility, but long, I'll tell you that.
Jamar Taylor, just a little bit taller. He pulls this one in for six.
Dustin rolling to his left, throws out there just over the outstretched hands of Jamar Taylor. I'm telling you, Jamar Taylor is something special now. That guy, if he stays healthy this year, he will rewrite all the receiving records at Texas A&M.
Shay, did Long look quicker there than he did last year to you?
Yeah, he actually does, Coach. I mean, Dustin Long has run head-to-head 40-yard dashes sometimes with these quarterbacks, and he's one of the fastest players on the football team in the skill position areas.
Pegram makes it a 6-3 ball game as he is good for the second time in as many tries tonight. So it's been a battle of field goals so far. A&M leads by a score of 6-3.
Have a child's birthday coming up? Let Poncho's Mexican Buffet host your next fiesta. A Poncho's birthday party has it all. Party balloons, traditional pinata break, Poncho's Buffet with drink, plus a colorful cake and ice cream, all served by your personal hostess. Best of all, it's only $6.99 per child. So just
raise the flag, you're ready for a little more Poncho Mexican Buffet.
Texas is reloaded and eyeing that elusive title. The lethal duo of Benson and Williams powers the Longhorns against New Mexico State. Tonight at 6 on Fox Sports Net.
Mike Sweeney and the Royals are in a battle for the AL Central crown as they take on A-Rod and the Rangers. Series begins Monday on Fox Sports Net.
Six to three, Texas A&M, thanks to two Todd Pegram field goals. They're on top of Arkansas State. Let's go down on the field with Randy McAvoy.
All right, appreciate it, Kevin. The folks here at Texas A&M call it the new standard in college athletics. What we're talking about is right here at Kyle Field. It's the Bright Family Football Complex. It's a multi-million dollar addition on the south end here at Kyle Field. Named in honor of H.R. Bump Bright, who served on the Board of Regents, also former owner of the Dallas Cowboys. It's got locker rooms, training and rehab centers, offices, and, of course, state-of-the-art academic center. It's first-class quality facility. Tell you what, the Aggies should be proud of this one.
Tell you what, Kevin, the Aggies are proud of that one. And you talk about an arms race and facilities among major D1 colleges. You're looking at the standard right there. That's an outstanding facility.
Arkansas State will get it back to the 29-yard line. Good return again. It's been good field position so far tonight. Terrence Dunbar, it was Easley that brought that one out. Out to the 31. That's where Arkansas State will go back on offense after a very impressive drive.
Hey, Kevin, those kickoffs are coming down a little short. I mean, we saw that one land around the 15-yard line in the previous kickoff when Arkansas State had really got good field position and landed around the 10-yard line. Suffice to say, there's a pretty significant wind blowing up high when that ball gets up. It's just holding it up and not letting it sail further down into the end zone.
Key play to that A&M scoring drive was the kickoff return of 60 yards to get it started. Here's a big play right up the middle. Flags down, but Antonio Warren breaks it off for a gain of 12 yards.
That's an impressive run right there by Antonio Warren, because as soon as he hit the line of scrimmage, he had the jet zone. Jackson Appel came up and laid a hit on him, but he still shook him off. He'll get the play call, the penalty call here.
Offside on the defense.
Pass
penalty is declined.
So let the play stand at a gain of 12 yards.
The offensive line continues to impress me from Arkansas State. They are really, really talented. They're big and they're strong, but they're talented. Tab Slaughter, the center, made a great block on that play.
He's 332 pounds, an anchor in the middle. Big man right there from Winnie, Arkansas. Crowd getting into it. Woo! Right up the middle. Brian Patrick was there to disrupt the play from the get-go, and he had plenty of help as well as Archie McDaniel stepped up from the linebacker spot. Big Brian Patrick, very strong young man, showed it here.
Very strong. Sophomore out of Pasadena, Rayburn. I'm telling you, when you can take a guy who's going one way and stop him and pull him back the other way, you got some grip strength, some arm strength, some good leverage. You got a whole lot of good things going on. Brian Patrick, nice job.
Three wide receivers set. On second down and 11. Warren lost it, got it back. Antonio Warren fighting near the sticks. Give him a gain of 10 yards. He's going to be about a yard short of the first down. Says, it was my fault dropping the football, but he picks it up and he's able to make a lot out of not very much. Archie McDaniel was there to make the tackle for A&M.
Coach, how about a fortuitous bounce here on enemy territory? That ball hits the ground, and how often do you see a football bounce right back up to you? Not very often.
Not very often, Shay. You got to be lucky.
Coach says that the only time he ever sees it happen is when the other guys
do it.
never happens like that for his team. Third down and 2. They're going to change personnel and call a timeout. I think they wanted a short yardage situation on the field. They didn't have the personnel for the play, so a smart...
The San Antonio Spurs are NBA champions once again.
Curl for three. Yes!
Celebrate their amazing victory with Sports Illustrated's Thrill Pack, featuring the official NBA Finals 2003 home video on your choice of DVD or VHS, plus the Sports Illustrated hardbound commemorative. This individually numbered classic gives an inside look at the Spurs' thrilling championship run. Both are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, giving you 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price.
Climbing walls!
This Spurs long sleeve champions t-shirt is also free when you use your credit card. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it's steel gray, lightweight, and fit for a champion. Call now. You'll get all three great Spurs collectibles free. This championship package is available exclusively for the number one team in the NBA from the number one magazine in sports, Sports Illustrated. Call now.
6-3 the score of the second quarter. Big third down coming up. Dennis Franchione in his A&M debut. They're looking for big things from him here in College Station, and why not? Look what he has done with turning over programs or turning them around. Before at Alabama, an improvement of 7 games coming into the next year. TCU the same after going 1-10. He took them to a bowl game the next year. New Mexico doing just about the same. He's going to try to do it again here. We did it Southwest Texas, Pittsburgh State, and Southwestern Kansas, where he started his career. Third down and 2. And that's a tough run for first down. That'll quiet about 75,000 for the moment.
Coach, you've been talking about the offensive line for Arkansas State, and you saw it right there. They just said, we need 2 yards. We're going to line up in the eye, nothing fancy. It's smash mouth football. We're going to battle you one-on-one. And on that particular play, Arkansas State's able to trudge through and pick up that first down.
Good surge. It was just a heck of a surge. See, Shay, the thing they got to do, the second best thing Arkansas State can do on offense is punt. They're still in the game. Yeah, just absolutely. Don't turn it over. Don't get too fancy.
Straight drop to throw, coming off the edge. Lost the football, McDaniel's got it. It'll be Texas A&M ball. They whistle him down, but Archie McDaniel came up with it. As you had the blitz coming off the edge, and they get to the quarterback in a hurry.
Yeah, I think that was the freshman parade All-American. Justin Warren out of Tyler Lee High School. Look at that, man. He was playing high school ball a couple of months ago. Closes right there on Elliott Jacobs. Delivers a huge hit right on the blind side. Archie McDaniel.
Yeah.
Man on the spot, man. Jumps on it, picks it up for the that's a big turnover right there. Coach, talk about things that can happen wrong.
See, that's what you can't do if you're Arkansas State. You've got to keep continuing to hold the ball, make first downs, stay in the game, but don't turn it over.
They did a good job of that on their scoring drive. They got really good field position on the kick, and they chewed up 7 minutes and 29 seconds on their field goal drive. So,
Dustin Long, here comes everybody. Threw it complete to Jamar Taylor.
Boy, you talk about some arm strength right there by Dustin Long.
Gain of 12.
Not only is he avoiding the pressure, and he starts to watch him. He's going to start retreating as he gets about right here. He sees all the pressure coming, throws it off his back foot, Coach.
And I think that's great concentration on Taylor, too, yes, catching that football.
And recognize when your quarterback's in trouble, go ahead and come back to the football here. There you go right there. Nice job, Jamar Taylor. And, boy, Dustin Long, that's a really nice throw off the back foot there.
Hard throw.
On first down and 10. Long again. This one complete. Terrence Murphy, and Terrence Murphy inside the 20-yard line of the 19. And this A&M offense is rolling right now. Lamar Lee was there to make the stop for Arkansas State. What a difference of momentum since that turnover. You just talked about it a moment ago. The worst thing they could do was turn the football over. And A&M looking to take advantage of it here.
Well, see, they had the crowd out of it for a while, and now their crowd is right back in it, all 80,000 plus of them.
Doesn't take much to flip that momentum switch, though, does it?
No, it doesn't.
You know, when it switches one way, it seems like it's always tough to switch it back.
No question about that. That's what first games are. They're momentum, a bunch of them.
On the option. Down to the 13-yard line for Courtney Lewis. Redshirt freshman. Folks getting their first look at him tonight, and a good look it is.
Well, there's something about seeing a number 25 in the A&M backfield with the name Lewis on the back of it.
Pretty good one in the
Darren Lewis.
Yeah, it is flashback. I've seen Darren Lewis a bunch. Hey, that's the first option play they've run tonight.
That's right. Yeah, you got a guy like Courtney Lewis. You want to get him the ball out on the corner because he's so quick, so fast a foot, but he'll fool you a little bit now. He's tough. He can run tough in between the tackles, but going open field, he's something else.
There's Lewis between the tackles, and he lost the ball. Les Eccles shot through like he right out of a cannon.
Did he ever?
Well, Les Eccles coming up. He's a returning starting linebacker. Now, they run like a 5-2 front, this Arkansas State.
4-2.
4-2. Excuse me, 4-2 front. And
let's see who's got the football here.
I tell you, Les Eccles made a bunch of plays tonight.
Here he is right through. Here. Is he diving in right there? Yeah, that did look like we're getting a replay. Our producer, Lee Friday, man on the spot, as he's saying, looks like the arm was down. They're still going to rule it a fumble, but A&M did get back on top of it, so that brings up about a 3rd and 7.
Line to make is the 11-yard line. 95 seconds to go in the first half. This one throw, tried to hit screen underneath, but read very nicely, and it's down at the 19-yard line as, again, Casey Venters is there. Senior from Kansas, young man, making the play there. So it's going to be a field goal time once again for Texas A&M.
You know, they got a good blitz package, Arkansas State. They brought a lot of heat that time, and A&M handled it good. They just made a big play.
Well, Casey Venters doing a nice job of coming up and really stopping that play before it ever had a chance to get started.
Pegram has been good from 42 and 32. And he's good again. 3 for 3 as it's been the Todd Pegram show here in this first half.
That'll make my golf easier next week, Kevin, because I play golf with his uncle.
There you go.
And he'll be happy.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know the life of a kicker now. It can go any way at any time. But I tell you what, he has made so much strides. The expectation of him coming out of Plano High School, Coach, was really big coming in. And they were really looking forward. And last year he did struggle a bit. Freshman year, 12 of 21 was all that he hit on field goals. Right now tonight, you can see that the year under his belt, the experience, and his dedication has really put him in a good spot now. And he's a big contributor on this offense.
No doubt about it. Plus, when you leave high school and you go to college, that is such an adjustment. You walk out there the first game, you're the starter, and you're by yourself kicking that ball. It's not like playing left guard.
80,000 eyes on you. That's right. Hey, yeah. Take a look here at the 1,000-yard rushers. This is one of the things that Les Caning, offensive coordinator, has talked about. Coach Fran has also talked about it. Hadn't had a 1,000-yard rusher since 1998. It's been 5 years, and If you look through here, there's not been a lot of 1,000-yard rushers, but, boy, when you start checking off some of these names, how about Darren Lewis, Curtis Dickey, George Woodard, Leland McElroy, Greg Hill.
I can attest to those guys.
you saw a lot of them, didn't you?
We tried to tackle them for a long time.
That's one of the things, though, that this A&M program is going to do. They're going to emphasize getting bigger and stronger up front. And when you need to knock people off the ball and run the football, that's where they want to get to. They're not quite there yet, but they got some excellent recruits that have come in this particular signing class. And then next year they've got a couple of them teed up as well. So look for them to make a big surge up front here.
Cameron will kick it into the wind. Terrence Dunbar out to the 20-yard line. Dunbar fighting out to the 23, and that's where Arkansas State will have the football here with 36 seconds to play. The first half has been all about the kickers and the defense. Jacobs, right now conventional wisdom would tell you he's just going to follow the football here, go to the locker room down by less than a touchdown and an extra point.
Coach, what's the call?
I believe that's it. Be conservative. don't try to go 90 yards.
Don't dig a hole. Don't dig a deeper hole.
No.
Instead, they hand it off to Jared Morris right there again.
How about that?
Another tackle here as Clinton Roy got his first carry of the first half. Now it's under a half minute to play. I still say you kneel down.
Yeah. Well, A&M's got three timeouts left, so they were going to force.
Yeah, that's true.
They're going to force everyone, and they might take a shot on trying to get a punt return. So if you're Steve Roberts, that's the right call. You can run the clock out. That's fine, but go conservative.
Yeah,
you're in the ball game right now. Don't do anything to put yourself further back.
Let her run out. There it goes.
And that'll do it here in the first half. So Texas A&M and Arkansas State in a tough and tight ball game. Dennis Francione had said earlier this was not just lip service. He thought this was going to be a game that could possibly be decided in the fourth quarter. And boy, what we've seen so far in the first 30 minutes of football here in College Station, he is absolutely right about that. Let's go down to Randy McElroy.
First half, Coach, you get 9 points. At least you got the lead going into the break.
Well, we got a punch win in the end zone. We didn't. Played fairly good on defense, and we got to find a way to get it in the zone on offense.
ASU has been effective with the blitz. What do you guys do to jumpstart the running game?
Well, we just got to pick some of those things up, and we got a plan to do it. But you know, we're seeing them full speed.
Thanks, Dennis Francione, heading to the locker room. His Aggies leading Arkansas State 9-3 here at Kyle Field in College Station. Halftime festivities coming up from Aggie.
One of the nation's largest universities, a spirit of family unity. A premier research institution, a commitment to undergraduate teaching, a legacy of service to others, a vision of leadership with integrity, guided by tradition, a force for change in our world. 45,000 students, one spirit, one vision. Texas A&M University.
Now that I'm married, I'm definitely feeling a little freaked out that I'm gonna sleep with only one person for the rest of my life.
We're officially starting fraternity.
It's genius.
I want in.
Remember the parties?
I promised my wife I wouldn't drink tonight. We're going streaking!
Remember the fun?
Ring the bell, you fancy.
It's time to go back. Old school.
It's clothing optional.
Yes!
Only on DirecTV pay-per-view.
This time, it's going to be different.
I'll beat him again.
This is the fight I want.
Your hands can't hit what your eyes can't see.
Shane, better be ready.
De La Hoya, Mosley 2, Redemption. Saturday, September 13th, live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View. Don't miss Redemption, live on DirecTV Pay-Per-View, Channel 101.
Believe me, Shane, I will get you.
You're still the same to me.
On Sunday.
Well, it's 9-3 A&M on top. Let's go down and onto the field. Take a listen to the Fighting Texas Aggie Band.
Oh.
20-yard line, the band executes the continuous block band countermark, sounding off to the Strategic Air Command line.
All over America, people are throwing out their cable boxes and switching to DirecTV. That's because right now when you call this toll-free number, you can get a free two-room DirecTV system with professional installation. You heard right. Get a DirecTV system with standard professional installation, a $250 value when you call Prime TV now. With cable, you can pay upwards of $45 or more each and every month for basic channels and still don't always get your favorites. Like do-it-yourself and food channels. If you're lucky, maybe your local cable company will offer them. But with DirecTV service, they're already here, including the best DirecTV programming. With access to over 225 available channels, featuring the best premium movie channels like HBO and Cinemax, Showtime, even Stars, Sports Pack, and favorites like NFL Sunday Ticket, with your choice of nearly every NFL game on Sundays throughout the regular season. Family programming, music choice, and DirecTV pay-per-view movies and events. Plus, you get access to your top local channels, all at a price that's a whole lot less than cable. With DirecTV service, you get digital quality pictures that make you feel like you're right in the middle of the action, and digital quality sound featuring state-of-the-art DVD quality. And now get 4 months free of DirecTV's best programming package, Total Choice Premier with local channels. That's right, you get over 225 channels free for 4 months, a $350 value when you call now.
Hey, knock it off up there.
Hurry! Call 1-800-906-9155 for your new DirecTV system. Just pick up the phone and call 1-800-906-9155 for your DirecTV system now. Offer ends September 30th, 2003.
It is 9-3 at halftime as Texas A&M in the 2003 opener. Arkansas State showing very well here in this first half as the Aggies with the 6-point lead on three field goals here in the first half. We welcome you back upstairs, Kevin Eschenfeld, alongside Spike Dykes and Shay Walker. So far in the first half, Coach, I'll start with you. I think A&M's got to get something going on the ground. They've got 13 carries right now for 13 yards.
Defense is tough. We talked about those defensive tackles coming to this game, and, you know, their linebackers are good. I say this, Arkansas State has got a good football team. I mean, they don't sound like much, and when you start talking about Division I school, they are a good football team. They're playing smart football. They got great pursuit, and I tell you something, they're playing a good football game.
Reggie McNeil and Dustin Long kind of splitting time, basically what we expected to happen in this first half. Your report card on that?
Well, I think both of them have done well in leading the offense, but what they haven't had, as you mentioned, the running game has been a little light for them, so it's really put a lot of pressure on them to throw the football and pick up first downs. The biggest stat that jumps out to me, Kevin and Coach, is the third down conversions. Arkansas State, 4 of 8. A&M is only 1 of 6 right now. They're going to have to improve on that in the second half.
All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from this first half. First half, it was all about field goal kickers, but defense got it going early on, and Jared Morris has just been outstanding in this ballgame.
All over the field, Kevin. I tell you, he has really played a good heck of a game.
Hey, take a look at Reggie McNeil. Some of the things he's able to do early on. Jamar Taylor, that was a big play right there for A&M. But Arkansas State, they have been want to do this throughout this ballgame, and there's a big play right there as
very
they come
fortunate.
Right back.
Yep, Sean Weston made excellent defense. He came over the top of the receiver, but Segal did a wonderful job of hanging on to it. And then you see Arkansas State getting a little aggressive with the running game. Shamar Bracey bringing it down. Now here's a big momentum for A&M as they get the kickoff return on special teams. And
Terrence Murphy.
Terrence out there in open field, man, and look out.
60-yard return. That would lead to another field goal. And then here we saw the big man, Dustin Long, come into the ballgame, and he went right to work.
Oh, what a great pass. That Coach Corner's hard to throw. It's hard to defend against, believe me.
Well, it's the defense again. This was a big play in the game.
That Justin Warren, the freshman All-American, came in and made that sack on Elliot Jacobs. Archie McDaniel falling on top of it, and then Dustin Long leading the offense down, getting him back into field goal position.
That Dustin Long looks quicker to me.
One of his three field goals in this first half. It is a 9-3 ball game right now. Texas A&M on top. And I guess in the second half, what adjustments are you looking for, Dennis?
I think probably open up a little bit, maybe spread them out a little bit more, and I don't think there's any doubt that we're going to see some hammering runs. I mean, we're going to see them. They've got to try to make some yards running.
Well, that's the thing that they're going to have to do, try to establish the running game, work it, and then the short to intermediate passing game is going to be key for them. We haven't seen them throw the ball or try to get the ball to the tight end yet, and that's been a question mark for them coming through fall camp. But if you can start to get a little bit of continuity like that, picking up some first downs, and really that third down conversion percentage, I expect to see it improve after some halftime adjustments, and you'll see A&M get back in this ball game and really do what they want to do offensively, and that's dominate.
All right, 30 minutes in the books here at College Station, week one of 2003. When we come back, Bill Burns scheduled to stop by, the athletic director at Texas A&M. We're back to College Station in a moment.
The back nine, the backwoods, a big fish, a nice dish, some soccer flair, a huge air. Get the widest variety of sports in Sports Pack with over 25 specialty and regional sports networks, all for only $12 or less per month. Order now at DirectTV.com or call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Get your world-class soccer in August on Fox Sports World. The best of worldwide soccer with the Barclaycard English Premier League, the German Bundesliga, the MLS, the Argentine Soccer, and the finals of the United Soccer Leagues. In August, it's all here on Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
On Fox Sports Net.
We welcome you back. 9-3, the halftime scores. Texas A&M is on top of Arkansas State. Take a look at some of the numbers from this first half. And a big number for Texas A&M right now was just 13 yards of rushing, and that's not going to get it done for the Aggies.
Okay, when we talk about it too, look at this. 1 of 6 on third down conversions. They've just not been in a good situation to make those pickups. And then, Coach, you were talking about this time of possession and how good that Arkansas State offensive line is playing. You get a good look at it right there.
Well, when they don't let A&M have that football and they don't turn it over, you know, they're just where they want to be because they're one play right now from being ahead in this ballgame.
That's right. And you talk about the kind of when you got two quarterbacks coming in and you're rotating those guys and you really want to see some continuity on offense, you got to have the football to do that. And
that's
when
right.
You're in between and you don't get the ball back for 6-7 minutes,
you're right.
It makes a little bit of difference.
And I think that's a big difference time-wise in one half. I'm telling you it is. And so, and A&M hadn't turned the ball over, so it's not like they're turning it over.
Yep, Arkansas State's playing a good ball game.
Yes, they are.
It doesn't get any easier for the Aggies. They've got Utah coming into town, and you can see that game if you call your local cable or satellite provider. Then on the 18th at Virginia Tech, Pittsburgh at Texas Tech, and some huge ones coming up at Nebraska, Oklahoma State at home, at Oklahoma, at Missouri, and of course, Texas here. A tough schedule for Texas A&M in 2003. Let's go down under the field. Randy McAvoy with a special guest, Bill Byrne.
All right, thanks a lot, Kevin. Standing by, you mentioned Bill Byrne, the director of athletics here at Texas A&M. Opening weekend, I know you're excited. You're wearing the maroon jacket. You're all decked out today, Bill.
Pretty good in it, don't I?
Talk about opening day here at Kyle Field. What a terrific crowd to usher in the Dennis Franchione era.
Well, you know, A&M has such a rich history, and it's wonderful to see all the Aggie fans come out and react to Coach Fran being here. So we're just thrilled to be here, and we put a lot of work in cleaning Kyle Field up and getting it ready.
I've been reading your website, the Wednesdays with Bill Byrne, checked it out a few days ago. You talk about game presentation on game days here at Kyle Field. That's really important for this department, isn't it?
Well, it really is. What we're looking for is having the fans have a complete experience. We want them to want to come back, win or lose, so that when they come to Kyle Field, they feel like they're very much a part of the game. And if you noticed from the introductions right until now, we're always including the fans in everything that we do.
Dennis Franchione's been a busy man since he got this job. Of course, in between, he had spring football. He has been making the rounds across the state, across the region. meeting the Aggie faithful, hasn't it?
Well, and you know, the Aggies are all across Texas and really all around the world. And Dennis has been around the state. All of us have been around the state, getting acquainted with the Aggie family and letting them know that we're going to continue these rich traditions that we have here.
Why was Franchione a good hire? Why was he a good fit for this program?
Well, first of all, he's from Texas, or he didn't grow up in Texas, but he's coached in Texas. He recruits in Texas. He knows Texas. He's a great football coach. And his success of building programs and the things that he does and the things that he stands for makes him a perfect fit for Texas A&M.
There's a lot of expectations. The natives are restless. They want a quick turnaround. They want to win and win big in the Big 12. Is that putting too much pressure on Coach Fran to turn it around that quickly?
Well, of course it is. Anytime you have a coaching staff change, there's a reason for the change. And it takes a while to bring your own athletes in. Now, luckily, we're able to bring our own coaching staff in. But what we're asking for is some time to go out and recruit some athletes and build the program the way I know our Aggie fans want it to be built.
Best of luck to you. Bill Byrne, Director of Athletics at Texas A&M. Thanks.
We'll see you.
All right, we're taking a break.
We're at the...
The San Antonio Spurs are NBA champions once again.
Call for three. Yes!
Celebrate their amazing victory with Sports Illustrated's Thrill Pack, featuring the official NBA Finals 2003 home video on your choice of DVD or VHS. Plus, the Sports Illustrated hardbound commemorative. This individually numbered classic gives an inside look at the Spurs' thrilling championship run. Both are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, giving you 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price.
Finding Wolf!
This Spurs Long Sleeve Champions T-shirt is also free when you use your credit card. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it's steel gray, lightweight, and fit for a champion. Call now. You'll get all three great Spurs collectibles free. This championship package is available exclusively for the number one team in the NBA from the number one magazine in sports, Sports Illustrated. Call now.
Well, it's 9-3, Texas A&M on top right now here at halftime. And week number one of the 2003 season is Todd Pegram with three field goals here in this first half, and that's the difference in the ballgame. 9-3, your score. Now some games. And it's college football season is here. And games of interest earlier today from the Big 12 is in St. Louis, Missouri over Illinois, 22-15, as they held on for dear life to win this one.
That's a big ball game for the Big 12. When you go out of conference like that, you're the Big 12, you're going up playing the Big 10, you want to try to hang a W on them. And the hats off to Coach Gary Pickle and that Missouri team for bringing that victory home.
And Nebraska with a win earlier today. I guess the demise greatly exaggerated of Nebraska as they knock off Oklahoma State in a huge game. The Blazers of UAB on top at Waco right now as the Guy Morris era begins there in Waco, but Watson Brown's Blazers on top by three in the third quarter, and Oklahoma with no problems right now over North Texas. It's Northern Iowa and Iowa State tied at 10 right now in the third quarter. The Cyclones having some problems with Northern Iowa, and that's a good football team, that Northern Iowa team. And Northwestern on top of Kansas in the third quarter, they lead it 14-3. Kansas State 34-5, and it is Texas Tech all over SMU. Colorado State and Colorado are tied. New Mexico State and Texas will play tomorrow on Fox Sports Net. Here we go in the second half. Terrence Murphy across the 20 to the 30. He's to the 40. Midfield, he may be gone. Tripped on his own man and down at the 15-yard line.
Oh, my.
That's just what the doctor.
Oh, my.
That's what the doctor ordered.
What a return. What a return. Terrence Murphy, you are something special, my friend.
Second one of the night, one for 60. You marked that one off at about 85.
I tell you what, Kevin, Coach, the way that he makes these cuts and moves in open field and just the head in, you're going to see him. He's going to turn upfield right here, and that's just to set that guy up a little bit more and give him some room out here on the hash. And then he has the speed to burst and makes it back across the middle of the field. Unbelievable run. Looks like Jamar Taylor might have got credit for the tackle, and boy, that's not the credit that you want. Oh, my goodness. What a turn, though, by Terrence Murphy.
So the Aggies with the ball in good shape as Reggie McNeil comes out under center.
Farmer, the eye back. Quick drop to throw. Complete to Taylor. Down to the 11-yard line and knocked out of bounds immediately. Lamar Lee right there with the sure tackle to knock him out of bounds.
Down by 17, Lamar Lee, and number 30, Chris Littleton. 6-yard gain on the play.
Gain of six. It'll be second down and four. Neal goes right to work to start here in the second half with very, very good field position.
Nice throw. That's a little dart. That's like a first down run used to be.
So. That's right. You get him up there in third, you start getting in second, three, and four. That's going to make your offensive coordinator and head coach a real happy man.
Farmer again, but right up the middle and not a whole lot there. Good penetration once again. Les Eccles is living in the A&M backfield right now, and he's not a defensive lineman. He's a linebacker.
Well, that's right, but you've got John Bradley and Corey Williams, them two big defensive tackles we've been talking about. They're tying up a lot of linemen, and that allows those linebackers to run free like that, and Les Eccles certainly taking advantage of it. And Derek Farmer, boy, I'm telling you, that guy, every time you see him run, hard runner, boy. He takes some shots. He kind of has that little forward lean, like little Eric Dickerson-esque. But, man, he gets it through and picks it up pretty hard. He's a tough runner inside the tackles.
And a blue-collar night for him tonight. He'll try to get on third down. Has the first down. Dragging white jerseys inside the 5-yard line.
Great run. Great second effort. That's running. That's taking him to the house right there.
That's running with the purpose right there. You see Derek Farmer as he comes off. Instead of trying to bounce the ball back to his outside, now he's just going to lower his head. He's going to run right over the top of the middle linebacker, Reggie Everett, and just drives the pile back. And I'm telling you, he's a tough physical runner. He's the leading rusher last two seasons for Texas A&M. First time that somebody's done that, I think, was that Kevin?
Greg Hill.
Greg Hill did it his freshman and junior, or freshman and sophomore years.
Yep, first Aggie since Greg Hill to do it the first 2 years, 1,242 career yards. Farmer, Megan Courtney Lewis, and Courtney Lewis down to the 4-yard line.
There's that boy Bradley.
He's on him again, isn't he?
Yeah. Those guys, those two tackles, they're not only good players, but they're huge. I mean, they're 300 pounds, and that's pretty good for size for a defensive tackle.
Well, but that, Coach, and the fact that they use their hands so well, mm-hmm. and to keep the offensive line off of them, in their lateral pursuit, now, I mean, normally you see guys that just kind of plug up and tie up, but these guys are, they plug up, tie up, and then they shed the blocker and go down and make a big old hit on them.
We saw Corey Williams chase down
Reggie McNeil earlier
on. Sure did. That's a good play.
Did he get in? He did. Touchdown.
That's the way to start off the third quarter if you're Texas A&M. Get a huge kickoff return by Terrence Murphy. And then you come right down and smartly put it in the end zone without a lot of hiccups or missteps along the way. Quick little pass out to Jamar Taylor giving you a second and about three. Then you get the running game going and driving off the ball. That'll start to build a little bit of confidence in that offensive line.
Again, personnel issues, and A&M's going to be forced to call it.
A&M's taking their first time out of this half.
They're going to be forced to call a timeout.
Well, Kevin, that was a great drive. That was started with a kickoff return, and, you know, that's just what A&M needed to start the second half.
Yeah, you like those 15-yard drives. That'll make Coach a long time, won't it?
Makes it a lot easier, no doubt about it.
We'll take another look at the touchdown run. Take a look at the right side of that offensive line. That goes hat on hat, and it creates a seam. And then, boy, you get your running back. You like to get him that close to the goal line. And when you do, don't try to dance around it, but just lower them shoulders, Coach, and drive right through there and get into the end zone.
That tight end, Taylor Schuster, did a great job on that play, didn't he? He came off, you know, co-op block, came off the tackle into the end.
He'll create that seam, and Courtney Lewis is able to knife it in for the touchdown.
Hey, these are two extremely well-coached football teams. They really are. They don't make a, it's not a sloppy game for the first game of the year.
Well, one of the things that a lot of the players have talked about is the attention to detail mm-hmm. that Coach Franchione has embodied in them since he arrived on campus, and it's a very sharp, crisp practice sessions that they've been going through, and it's there's no in-between time or no downtime. It's pretty much, hey, here's the drill that you're supposed to be in. You get there, you do that, mm-hmm. then you're on to the next one. It's very sharp, very precision-oriented. And attention to detail is a big thing for Coach Fran. And the kids, to a man, they've all said that, boy, he's on top of things and he's on top of everything.
Yeah. Well, That's Dennis Franchione. That's the deal. That's what he's always been. He's been a micromanager and a heck of a football player.
Pegram for the point after he got it. So with 12:53 to go, huge kickoff return, set up a short drive, and it's 16-3 Aggies.
This is college football. Texas is reloaded and eyeing that elusive title. The legal duo of Benson and Williams powers the Longhorns against New Mexico State. Tonight at 6 on Fox Sports Net. Mike Sweeney and the Royals are in a battle for the AL Central crown as they take on A-Rod and the Rangers. Series begins Monday on Fox Sports Net. Fox NFL Sunday returns next weekend.
Aggies on top, first touchdown of 2003. It was to Courtney Lewis. They kick it away. And again, another good return by Terrence Dunbar as he brings it out to the 30-yard line.
Now, Kevin, Arkansas State special teams have played pretty well, especially in the kickoff return department, because they have given Elliott Jacobs in that offense fairly good starting field position almost on every drive that they've had so far.
And he's made the most of it so far in this first half, although hasn't really translated into points for Steve Roberts' team. Now the Aggie defense trying to make a statement as Arkansas State has it for the first time here in the second half. Crowd into it. Right up the middle and big time hitting. Again, Jared Morris, the first man to submarine through to make the stop. Archie McDaniel was there as well.
Yeah, there's a little bit of confusion between Jared Morris and Archie McDaniel. Jared was trying to get Archie on one side. Archie was trying to go to the other. But Jared Morris showing that leadership, leading that first middle linebacker coach in Texas A&M defenses in 20 years. And had a middle linebacker run that other scheme.
That's exactly right. He reminded me of the middle linebacker we used to have at Fulton, Zach Thomas.
Well, I was going to say, that's what I was thinking of as well.
He really has got a little Zach Thomas in him. He is a good football player. Look at that suit back. Roaring.
Nothing doing.
Hey, highlight that. We need to see that.
Ronald Jones was a man that really got there first that time. Ronald Jones stepping up and holding up the receiver or the running back, and Jared Morris finished him off.
Watch him all the way. That's football right
there.
That's
keeping that pursuit going, isn't it? Running right down, that's what you want your linebacker to do, that side-to-side pursuit. And, boy, when you get there, come with a little bit of intensity, and he does that for sure.
He really does.
Third down and 6. Early here in the second half. Throw it underneath, complete. First down. And a huge hit. Appel came in and really laid the lumber in there, but the catch had already been made and the damage had been done as Gary Vincent with his first catch of the night.
That's kind of one of those where the cornerback, Sean Weston, is going, man, please hit the receiver when you come up. Now, Sean Weston doing a nice job of holding on, not giving up any additional yards. But, boy, Jackson Appel is a finisher now.
And Brian Patrick was finishing from the other end.
Yeah, come, that old sophomore from Friendswood can lay a lick on you. And Brian Patrick, as you said.
Oh, Jacobs threads the needle now. That was a nice pass.
Yes, it was.
That's a big conversion to pick up another first down for the Arkansas State offense.
Gracie lost the football out of bounds, but they're going to whistle him down. Beg your pardon? They will say that it went out of bounds.
It's going to back him up about 2 yards from where he was, but that's Jackson Appel again, the guy that we're talking about. As he comes up, Kevin, did a nice job of getting his hand on that football and ripping it. And when you're in a scrum like that, coach, and you got to protect and hang on to the football.
Shamar Bracey would have had 9. Instead, it's only going to be a gain of about 6 or 7 yards. Appel almost got to it. Give him a gain of 7, so it's 2nd down and 3. Shamar Bracey's really been impressive in this ballgame. 4 carries, 33 yards. Bracey again up the middle to midfield. Knocked off his feet by Jared Morris.
That big front the coach has been talking about, Steve Gibbs, Ted Slaughter, and Frank Harris doing a nice job right there creating a seam. One, I'll tell you, Bracey, he can hit a hole.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that it just continues to amaze me how good that offensive line is coming off the line against a good defensive line.
Yep. And knocking them off the ball and creating a little bit of seams.
They've outgained A&M on the ground 3-1 right now. 76 yards to 24. Well, comebacker. Was there for the big hit. Jerome Stegall was not looking at the football. He was looking at what was coming.
And that's when you're the defensive secondary coach. You want your guy. You go, Jackson, we love the intensity. I love the way you hit. But, boy, look for the football. My goodness, he's looking for the hit. He brings it down. Oh, nice job right there.
You got to put cotton in his ears.
I'm telling you, he brings a load now.
One of those ones, you may as well catch it because you're going to get hit anyway.
That's right.
Foot steps. Hey.
It's going to hurt a little bit less if you catch the football. Second down and 10. Bracey again on the delay.
Oh, he's strong.
It's a draw play. Goes for another gain of about 7 yards. It would look like it could be a third down and long. It'll be a third down and 3.
Well, I'll tell you, Shamar Bracey just coming in waves. The guy's 6'2", 225 pounds, but boy, he runs with some authority, and he's tough to bring down.
Well, Shay, you say he runs 4.38, and that's unbelievable to do that size. He is a good player. He's got good tilt.
He's averaging 7 yards a carry in this game without really breaking off a big one.
They got Terrence Dunbar back there now.
On the quick slant, another third down conversion. Linus Smith came in with a big hit late, but once again, Chuck Walker there to make the catch and hold on.
Coach, you talk about Elliott Jacobs and his precision passing. And boy, when you run that little two route, that quick slant like that, you've got to have the ball. If you're the wide receiver, that ball's got to be right on your numbers because you don't want to be stretched out or laid out for it. And Elliott Jacobs delivered a dart.
That's precision. That's
Chuck Walker right there, right on the, just perfect.
Hey, he's played within himself, no doubt about it.
Another first down. Under 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. Bracey almost lost the handoff. Gets a couple before Jared Morris with another tackle.
Jared Morris, they won't have to rock him to sleep tonight.
I don't think so. He may rock somebody to sleep tonight.
Yeah, he's been all over the field. He's really played well.
Justin Warren, also a young man who forced a fumble earlier, is in on that stop. Now second down and 9.
This is a big play in this whole deal right here, this game. This might be the biggest one in the game.
Right up the middle, Jolly hit him immediately. And maybe a gain of a couple inside the 30, but another big third down coming up. And the way Arkansas State has been on third down, they got them right where they want them.
Third and 9 is not good, though, Kev. I like those third and 2s a lot better. You know what I'm saying?
But the pressure from the end, David Rawls came in on that play. And he was able to get back in the backfield and kind of hit the running back before he got any chance to get any momentum started bringing up this third and 8.
Line to make is a 21-yard line. The numbers, an impressive night for Elliott Jacobs. The left-hander looks in, throws, picked off by Appel. Jackson Appel. After the 45-yard line.
And boy, you talk about some nifty footwork. He read that play perfectly, Kevin, from his safety position. Arkansas State has been making a lot of these third down conversions, Coach, when they've been coming in and just throwing them little dinks right between the hash marks, either to a crossing inside receiver or to one of your running backs. And you see Elliott there, he tries to zip it in there, but Appel reads it perfectly, comes in and breaks it up. And boy, what a heads-up play on the tip drill to keep the concentration on it. Not a bad little piece of running right there.
Probably running, it really is.
And probably the first bad decision Elliott Jacobs has made tonight.
But I tell you, that was a great read, though, by Jackson Appel.
Yes, it
looked like he was open, and Appel closed there, and an eyelash topped it up and then made the interception.
Farmer in the backfield behind Reggie McNeil. The comes the pressure. McNeil going up top, going deep. And this one intercepted. It'll be, in effect, a punt. Jonathan Burke with the INT as it'll go back to Arkansas State. Don't deep like, in their own territory.
You don't like punting on first down.
Nope,
no,
you
do
sure
you?
Don't, do you?
No, you really don't. But that is a good thing about it. It is like a punt. It's just, you just waste a possession.
But it looked like on that particular play, though, that Reggie was expecting Murphy to stay to the outside because he just absolutely flat airmailed it to the outside. And that was good coverage out there by Arkansas State defense. And, yeah, and Murphy was running inside, and that ball just continued to sail on the outside. Take a look here. You're going to see Murphy. He's going to slant to the inside here. As he's slanting inside, you get it down here. And you'll see where he's all the way in by the numbers. There's the defender right there playing outside the hash, making the interception.
Now, this is the second turnover of this game, one on each side. Nice move of the line of scrimmage. Out to a 20-yard line. It talked about having five tailbacks and not exactly sure which one was going to get the nod. Well, everyone has been impressive so far. Antonio Warren on the carry there. He and Shamar Bracey have really opened some eyes. It's a gain of 9 yards to the 20-yard line.
You know, those backs run tough, Kevin. They really are hard to arm tackle. You just can't do it.
Jacobs being chased, brought down. Scott Duquesne got there first.
Scott Duquesne, what a great job he did, Coach. Out there in open field on a quarterback, coming from the linebacker position and the closing speed that he had to get there, because you would have thought at a minimum Elliot Jacobs would have been able to turn it upfield and pick up the first down. Nobody out there, and then you always see Duquesne running in there. That's hustle and desire right there.
No doubt. Plus, I tell you, the lateral speed of the A&M defense is good. They've got really good lateral speed.
Murata Manning also there to make the stop. So a third down and about two. No way.
Jonte Bull. Wow, what a play. I mean, you're talking about a cornerback. You own an island enough as a cornerback when you're trying to defend the pass. Take a look at him as he's getting it. We've seen these Arkansas State running backs, especially Antonio Warren. He's been ripping runs off. The boy Bull doing a great job of coming up, keeping that leverage and keeping that outside shoulder clear, where he's able to bring down that running back without a first down. That was a big-time play.
A loss of two on a third down and two, so now it's punt time. I haven't seen Jared Little in a while. Jason Carter back deep for A&M.
Good.
Wow, what a catch.
Yeah, Carter take this one over his shoulder. Eluding a couple men and out to the 40-yard line, to the 41-yard line where A&M will have it. 5:04 to go in the third quarter. A&M gets the football back. They lead it by a score of 16-3.
My DirecTV DVR with TiVo, it rocks.
Oh, I love this machine.
I'm hooked.
It's awesome.
It does it all.
With my DVR,
I can record
Trading Spaces,
the practice,
with one click for the entire season.
With a season pass, I don't miss one show ever.
Oh, and you can pause live TV
and walk the dog.
Come back and continue watching where I left off.
It's a real gift.
I can't tell you, it has changed my life.
It's TV on my schedule. It's that simple.
DirecTV DVR. Call 1-866-GET-A-DVR for an exclusive customer offer.
You know what I love about you? You're a triple threat. Most backs only get your points in fantasy football by running the ball.
Not you. Not my first round pick, Marshall. You run, catch, and score.
Did you see when I scored 4 touchdowns?
I see every one of your plays. The screen, off tackle, straight up the gut. You keep it up, and we are going to go far.
See the games you want to see with the choice of nearly every NFL game on Sundays. NFL Sunday Ticket only from DirecTV.
On Sunday.
A&M on top, 16-3 in the third quarter. Let's go down to Randy McAvoy.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Kevin. What a weekend here in College Station. It all, of course, started last night with Midnight Yell, but prior to that, a new class, a new induction class in the A&M Athletics Hall of Fame for the class of 2003. Here at Kyle Field in the South Zone, Mike Arthur, class of 90, goes in along with Red Burdett from the class of 47. Of course, he was greeted by A&M Athletic Director Bill Byrne. What a night here at Kyle Field last night.
And you got a chance, Shea Walker, to check that out last night.
Yeah, I was there last night. What a great event it was. Mike Arthur, well-deserved first-team All-America center here at A&M and went on to have a great career in the pros as well.
Handoff right up the middle. Fullback Keith Joseph. And Alex Peoples, his number sake, on the other side, making the stop.
I'll tell you what, last night, too, we saw Red Burdett was inducted to the Hall of Fame. And I'll tell you, he was a great speaker, gave an awesome speech. And when he got up there, he said, hey, why am I here? I don't know. But I did letter in three sports at A&M. He's like one of the few guys that actually lettered in three sports, so. Good athlete. Boy, like I said, it was a great way to kick off opening weekend here in College Station.
Second down and 6. After a gain of 4 by Joseph. Option play, McNeil. Close to the first down, but he'll be short. He's taken right down at midfield. Walker with the tackle. Eddie Walker, junior from Fordyce, Arkansas. This is coach. This turnovers. Penalty and penalties is a lot. What you see a lot of early on in the season. We haven't seen much of that tonight at all.
No, I think these teams both played well. I really do. They, they've kept their poise. They've hustled. There's not any loafing. There's not anybody. This is a good football game.
There have been 3 penalties called in this football game.
That's impressive for a first ball game.
2 against Arkansas State and 1 against Texas A&M.
And one of those, the crowd was down 1 yard line.
Just as we say that,
well, you brought in the SI jinx, the SI cover jinx.
The bearer of bad news.
Well, that's a little false start.
You really shouldn't have gone there.
False start on the offensive line.
I'll tell you another thing happened this week.
Prior to the snap,
we lost a great
on the
great
offense,
coach,
5
Jim
yards,
Walker.
Still
he
third down.
This last week,
no doubt. No
and
doubt.
He meant more to college football than nearly anybody I ever met in my life, and it is a real loss to the coaching profession. And you know, Jim Wacker's a guy who just loved the game.
Absolutely.
And
loved life.
Oh, just loved everything. And he, you know, that's the way he was. And he was certainly an inspiration to a lot of people. We're going to miss Jim.
Absolutely. And he was a big part of that, kind of the same way that Dennis Franchione came through there at Southwest Texas.
No doubt. Same format.
Yep. Won a national championship there at Southwest Texas. This one completes. And it's enough for a first down out of the 48-yard line of Arkansas State. As Jason Carter was there to make the catch. There's certain guys on this team that, you know, you talk to people and they go, this is a guy that's really going to have a breakout year. They talk about people like Courtney Lewis and Jason Carter, I think, come to the top of that list.
Kevin, Jason Carter was a third-string quarterback, and he kind of went to the coaches and said, hey, I want to be involved in the ball game. I want to be more involved in the offense. And so they started putting him at the A-back. He runs the ball now. He catches the ball. He had 146 yards. Combined yards in the spring game, and he's a big-time weapon, and you'll see him a lot as this A&M season progresses.
This one complete. Terrence Murphy. And now A&M starting to go to work on the offensive side. Beg your pardon. It was Terrence Thomas. It was number 3, not number 5, as Thomas makes his first catch of the night.
You know, the thing about it, Reggie McNeil has been the least mobile of the 2 quarterbacks tonight. You know, Dustin Long is thrown on the run, and Reggie's sitting in the pocket pretty good. It's sort of amazed me. Just the opposite of what I thought it was going to be.
Well, it's the opposite of what you would expect, but I think Reggie now lining up in the shotgun is giving him a little, it gives you about, what, a count and a half longer when you're in the shotgun so you don't have to quite run for your life off the drop back.
You're right.
Second down, less than a yard.
Here comes the pressure. Here comes the football. Complete. Thomas knocked out of bounds.
Well, you talk about some nice hands right there by Terrence Thomas. Not an easy catch to make. Running full speed, and Reggie doing an outstanding job of laying it. Right, here's Terrence Thomas lined up in the slot. He's going to run it out there. See him stick those hands out? Well, that's what you want your receiver to do. Stick those hands out. Don't try to get it up there in the number in the jersey when you're running that kind of an outcut. Because if you do, you're more than likely going to bobble it.
Sounds like a guy that ran a few outcuts right here in this same stadium.
I ran a few, but I don't know if I ever ran them that fast.
From the 25-yard line, first down and 10. Second catch of the night for Thomas. Back-to-back catches. McNeil cuts it up, 20. Hit by Peoples and driven to the turf at the 16-yard line.
Kevin, you're seeing the effects now of the A&M offense and the versatility of it. And Les Canning doing a great job of play calling right now, offensive coordinator. He's got this Arkansas State defense on their heels a little bit. Now, they're making some tackles, and they're in the right position. But, you know, when you start to throw the football, you're getting the slot receivers catching the ball in the outcuts, then you run the option. They're seeing a lot of offensive versatility right now, and I think it's got Arkansas State a little bit confused.
90 seconds to go in the third quarter. Up the middle, Farmer. They're giving forward progress to the 11-yard line. He's pushed back rudely. Alex Peoples again in to make the tackle for Arkansas State, but not before he got to the 11 and plenty for another first down.
A lot of different formations, Jay. Yep. Every play is a different formation, and that's nerve-wracking for a defense.
Well, once they're starting to dial the numbers and they're starting to all come up and they're starting to hit a bunch of them, then it really gets you confused and you don't know what personnel said to bring in. But you see Derek Farmer, coach, running like that. When he gets hit, you always worry about a guy when he gets hit like that if he's going to get stripped or stopped, because he just keeps on churning and plugging. Then, boy, you got five, six defenders, everybody ripping at the football.
Oh, you do.
It gives you a little pause in the pause in the pulse there.
Now from the 12-yard line, first down and 10. Again, McNeil. Great tackle. Again, Les Eccles was there as Courtney got the handoff.
I guess that's the biggest change in college football in the last 10 years, Shay, is the fact that people work on stripping the football. A ball carrier has no chance. I mean, it is a son of a gun to go play a game without thumbing anymore, because people are stripping.
Yeah, you're talking about, and you're running full speed, and then most, or more often than not, you see those strips come when the guy's fighting for that second and third effort, which is what you want your running back to do.
Sure.
You want him out there fighting, but boy, when you get plugged up and there's seven, eight guys around, you're ripping at the ball, you just hope the whistle blows or you go down.
That's exactly right.
Loss of a yard on first down, second down and 11, and it's going to be a third down and 11 coming. Had a little high and outside for the intended receiver. Big third down on the way. Terrence Murphy couldn't quite get to that one.
Might have landed a little awkward there. Looks like he's coming off the sidelines. They're going to bring Terrence Thomas in the ball game. Terrence Murphy laid out for that. He was horizontal to the ground. Hit it a little hard. Looks like it might be a little shaken up.
The big thing A&M's got to do, they got to ring the bell right now and get some points on the board, because you're going to make it a two-touchdown, two-extra-point game.
Well, it's a third down and 12. They got to get the ball inside the two-yard line. Arkansas State.
Casey Venters
wanted a timeout.
Yeah, Casey Venters, Kevin, in the secondary, he was up there yelling for a timeout.
You know why? He only had nine other teammates on the field at the time.
That's a good reason.
11 on 10, doesn't work. A&M on top, 16.
Tools, tools, tools. When you got a job to do, they're always on your mind. And that's why you trust the store that loves tools as much as you do. More people buy their tools from Sears than anywhere else in America, because only Sears has the best selection and all the top brands, including Craftsman, America's number one tool brand. Right now, during our great weekend sale, find all Craftsman mechanics tool sets, all Craftsman tool storage, and all paint on sale. Sears, good life, great price.
At Poncho's all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet, you'll always get real food at fast food prices. Have kids? Children under 5 eat free every day, and our big kids buffet is just $2.99 with free drink and dessert. Let Poncho's host your child's next birthday party with cake, balloons, pinata break, invitations, and Poncho's buffet with drink, all for only $6.99 per child. Poncho's customers come in all ages and sizes. Still hungry?
Raise the flag, you're ready for a little more Poncho's Mexican buffet.
Well, third down and 12 coming. You're really starting to see A&M mix things up as far as formations. I think there's a little confusion. That's what caused it for Arkansas State.
Well, as Coach had mentioned earlier, though, they're bringing in different formations. They're running from the spread. They're running from the eye. They're bringing in different packages. And when you do that as a defense, as an offense, then it forces the defense to bring in their personnel package. Casey Venter's very alertly calling a timeout because this is a huge third down.
Yes, it was. And 10 people won't cut it.
Got to get it inside the two-yard line for a first down. It's a second, they're making a third down and 12. McNeil under pressure, throws incomplete. Had his man Terrence Thomas, but he couldn't hold on.
It's a good pass, good pattern, and great defense.
Well, hit him in the hands right there. That was that cover two look again, and they were trying to get the post corner and slide it in. And that ball had a little bit more pace on it because the safety was bearing down on Terrence Thomas. Just not able to hit. Ball hit him in the hands. Good throw by Reggie.
Yes, it was.
Todd Pegram has been good from 42, 32, and 35, and now he tries it from 30 yards out. Make it a 19-3 game. He does his job.
Hey, he's been the star of the show tonight. Now he's done a nice job, and when they really needed it the most, early on when they were struggling a little bit.
Well, he's responsible for 12 A&M's 19 points. We got 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Texas A&M taking care of business tonight here against Arkansas State. And they'll try to do it again next week against the Utes of Utah.
Hey, this Utah team. They're under their first-year head coach, Urban Meyer, who came over from Bowling Green.
Right.
And let me tell you what, Bowling Green, 1,000-yard receivers, 1,000-yard rushers, they've been putting it up. Utah just beat their in-state rival, Utah State, last weekend by 20. So, I mean, Utah coming into A&M next Saturday is going to be a big test for this young A&M team.
Well, you know, the good thing about A&M is tonight, every quarter, they're better than they were the previous quarter.
Well, and that's what you want to see in that first game. And I'll tell you what, another thing about this Utah State game, Kevin, Utah played Utah State on Thursday night. So they're going to get a couple extra days of practice in. And, boy, you know that difference, Coach, is a quantum leap from first week one to week two.
Well, that's the biggest week of the year, they say. And you make more improvements between the first game and the second game you do any time of the year. And when you have two extra days, believe me.
Makes a difference, doesn't it?
Makes a heck of a difference. No question.
Well, Pegram will kick it away again as Terrence Dunbar goes deep for Arkansas State. And the return team has been very good for Arkansas State. Also, Chris Easley back deep.
You know, the kickoffs have not been very deep, though, Kevin.
Not into this win.
No.
That's not good. Try to get it out of bounds. Did he get it? It's Arkansas State football.
There is some tense moments right there for Coach Steve Roberts.
Yeah. That'll get you gray-headed fast right there.
Oh, my goodness. Either headed or falling out. I'm not sure which, but one or the other.
One or the other.
Wow.
Terrence Dunbar couldn't hold on. When he dropped it, he kicked it.
All right, Kevin, I think you're going to be officially cut off. You talk about the game being well played, no penalties being called. Boom, we get a penalty. You talk about the return team setting up, having a great time.
Call me the Grim Reaper.
I mean.
So it's all the way back to the 7-yard line.
Arkansas State player down on the field right now.
That's the first time we've had anybody on the field.
Yeah.
That tells you about the condition of both of these teams.
I'll tell you, it's a pretty muggy night. Now.
Yes, it is. And there's not been anybody even
been
attended
up
to.
Or
no, it's been a... They're both in good condition.
You always, when a guy's down like that, it don't matter what team he's on, you always want to see the young man get up and be able to carry, walk himself off the field.
That's Michael Soule who did just that. There's 6 seconds to go in the third quarter. First down and 10. This place is rocking now. Right up the middle and not a whole lot there.
Ooh, a lot of noise, though. That was Justin Warren, the freshman, All-Parade All-America freshman out of Tyler Lee, coached by Mike Owens.
So three quarters in the books here at College Station. Dennis Franchione's 2003 and Texas A&M debut so far has been a hard-hitting one. Some big plays. And Dennis Franchione's team is on top, 19-3.
The equipment that the Navy has is state-of-the-art.
A lot of the equipment that I work with is leading technology.
I spent most of my Navy career working in satellite communications.
I actually went through 15 months of school.
Been through very extensive training in mathematics, physics, chemistry.
They train you to be the best, and they expect you to be the best.
It probably would have cost me around $25,000 for the total amount of training I went through.
My parents were very excited that the Navy was going to pay for 4 years of college.
College professors come aboard to teach us while underway.
I am two courses away from my criminal justice degree.
What you've seen is just part of the story. Call this number now for your free 12-minute video and see how the Navy can jumpstart your life. Check out the jobs, training, and money for college that are waiting for you.
My Navy experience allowed me to step right into a respectable and fun job.
Navy, accelerate your life.
Texas is reloaded and eyeing that elusive title. The lethal duo of Benson and Williams powers the Longhorns against New Mexico State. Tonight at 6 on Fox Sports Net. Mike Sweeney and the Royals are in a battle for the AL Central crown as they take on A-Rod and the Rangers. Series begins Monday on Fox Sports Net.
Top 19-3 as we start play here in the fourth quarter in Arkansas State in a hole facing a second down and 8.
Well, get ready for the noise.
Yep, all the way back from the 9-yard line. It's going to be a little rowdy in that end of the field. To the fullback. Fighting out to the 14-yard line. Really nice job running there because it didn't look like a lot for Orin O'Neill, but able to get it out there for a gain of 4 yards.
He
so third
hit.
Down coming up.
Kevin, you're right. He got hit early by about two or three A&M defenders. And I'm telling you, big Orin O'Neill, 239-pounder, just lugged about three or four maroon jerseys with him, picking up about 4 yards. So making this a much more desirable third down.
Third down, 3. And the first down out to the 19-yard line, and a big first down it was from Antonio Warren.
You know, Kevin, I can't get over, I've not been in this stadium as a spectator in a long time, and I can't get over the spirit. I mean, you know, they talk about Spirit of Aggieland. I mean, this is unbelievable, and it really is. When you're in that north end zone, you're lucky if you hear anything. I don't know how they ever run a play down. Do you, Shaq?
Well, you got to go off hand signals. I mean, you know what that's like. You played in a lot of hostile environments. Mm-hmm. Well, I tell you, this place can really get loud. It's bigger than it used to be. It's bigger and it's closed in now.
Yeah.
And louder. Antonio Warren. Marcus Jasmine, the biggest player on this team at 6'5", 320 pounds, just pushed his man right into the offensive backfield.
That brings a little bit of noise with it, too. Here's Marcus Jasmine, the junior out of De La Salle High School in New Orleans, just refusing to get blocked and stay blocked. Shed the guy off and Nike way into that backfield and dropped the running back for a couple-yard loss. That's been a big plus for A&M because these Arkansas State backs have been able to rip off some pretty nice games.
He was lucky to lose just a yard. Lucky didn't lose the football. Jacobs, quick straight, drop the throw, does complete. Short gain as Cox made the catch out near the 25-yard line.
He had some little quick feet there and a little rush coming in there.
Oh, yeah, quarterback. You don't want to see a quarterback get happy feet, but he did a nice job keeping, as Kevin's been talking about all day, that poise. That poise is staying there under pressure. I'll tell you what, though, you see Mike Cox go up and catch the ball. He played junior college in California. He broke Jason Seahorn's receiving record. How about that?
Yep. I'll tell you what, he's pretty darn good, man.
David Ross was there applying the pressure. It'll bring up a big third down and 5. Again, the pressure. This one almost intercepted. That big Brian Patrick, I believe it is.
Well, the pressure was great right there. Now, Elliot Jacobs did a nice job of trying to stay away from him. He just couldn't retreat fast enough. See Big 99 David Ross bearing down on him, getting that tip. And, oh, Brian Patrick says.
I believe those big linemen are getting tired a little bit now. That big 318-pound line is, they're winning just a little bit. They played a lot of football, though. They've had the ball longer than A&M's had the ball.
Yeah, by 6 minutes. It's not real close. Get the kick away. Jason Carter. Good coverage.
Well, I tell you, you love your return men on punts to be fearless. And Jason Carter right there, after he got lit up on that first punt return, he's still back there, coach, catching those balls. And looks like the guys are flying all around him. And he's still able to pick up some yards and get an A&M offense a pretty good field position.
I'm going to make a prediction to you, Shay.
All right.
I believe we might see number five, Mr. Martin, back returning punts before long. Ladies, return those kickoffs.
Well, I tell you what, not a bad call, coach.
Well, I tell you, he's had three of the finest kickoff turns I've seen in years. I mean, and you're talking about making people miss. He's done it.
I'll tell you, the way he does it, too, with that speed. I mean, he just, every move that he makes and every cut is always at full speed. That's not easy to do.
No, it's not. It's really not.
Dustin Long running the show now, and Dustin wanting to go deep. As a man, intercepted. Jonathan Burke. Down at the 5-yard line. But Terrence Murphy looked like he had a step.
Kevin Terrence was in a little bit of bracket coverage. You're going to look up here, and Dustin, the offensive line, doing a great job of giving him enough time to look down. Bracket coverage, he goes up over the top, and that was just a one-on-one deal. And here you see Jonathan Burke, man on the spot. We've seen and called his name a lot, but he was playing back in that bracket a little bit deeper, and since he was a couple yards off, it allowed him the opportunity to come under and catch that tip ball to the interception.
Well, he had room to run as well if he hadn't slipped down there. But now again, in that closed-in end. Good luck. Maybe a gain of a yard.
Now I talked about Justin Warren. He was on that tackle as well, being from Tyler Lee. He played for my old defensive coordinator from high school, Mike Owens.
Yeah, I'll tell you that.
Port Arthur Jefferson, Mike Owens is my D coordinator while I was in high school.
Is that right?
Yep.
Well, let me tell you this. He's a good football coach. He's turned out some great players.
He sure has. And I know A&M is very, very happy to have Justin Warren in the fold. And that's, I mean, this kid's a true freshman. He's out there laying some leather and playing some good football.
No gain there. Second down and 10. Ballard took it to the line of scrimmage.
Tipped to the line of scrimmage.
How's that for being improvising?
Caught by the quarterback.
Yeah. Elliot Jacobs, take it back. Going to go ahead and run with it. Why not?
That keeps your completion average up.
Yes, it does. But I tell you what it does. It's a little deflating for the defense because they did everything right on that play.
Sure.
That play should have been an incomplete tip ball pass or possibly an interception, but certainly it shouldn't have been a reception by the quarter, by the guy who threw it, and then he ends up picking up about 4 yards.
And it's close to a big play. I mean, really, if you break one tackle, he could have a heck of a play.
Johnny Jolly was there to knock it away, but knocked it up in the air, came right back to Elliot Jacobs, but now a third down and 6.
Elliot Jacobs doesn't like what he sees, Kevin. Calling a timeout right now.
Well, a timeout of the field. Third down and 6 when we come back. And the Aggies leading 19-3.
Just watch college football. I live it. And so do the serious fans. I hold my breath on fumbles and let it out on touchdowns just like you. I also know it's not how many games you watch, but how good those games are. That's why you go for the maximum choice of games.
Experience the best of college football. Order ESPN Game Plan from DirecTV to get up to 12 top games from around the country. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or log on to DirecTV.com today.
It's the most exciting 2 hours on television. NWA Total Nonstop Action Wrestling. Jeff Jarrett, Raven, Elo Brown, AJ Styles, and the man they call Sting. It's the most exciting 2 hours on television. It's NWA Total Nonstop Action Wrestling on pay-per-view.
On the next Beyond the Glory, Bobby Bowden turned FSU into a football powerhouse.
It was like the children of Egypt being freed from bondage.
He stood by his players during tough times.
He takes a lot of heat for giving people second chances, but that's what dads do.
And became a legend doing things his way.
The one thing I've tried to do in coaching is not let public opinion tell me what to do.
Bobby Bowden, Beyond the Glory, next on Fox Sports Net.
Welcome back to Kyle Field, prestigious Aggie here from the class of 1972, the Honorable Governor Rick Perry. Check it out, the opener for the Coach Fran era tonight.
It's a big night, a lot of excitement here. Just almost a full house, I imagine up close to 80,000. And as you can tell by the sound behind us, there's still lots of excitement in here, even with a pretty good padded lead.
Now, you're a former yell leader, so you know how to get the crowd going, don't you?
Well, it doesn't take a lot, Texas Aggies, I guarantee you. They come regardless of what the score might be, but they always like to see it with the Aggies on top.
You rarely miss a home game, do you?
Very rarely. We try to come over. It's not too far a drive, so driving over from Austin's a treat for us.
Enjoy the rest of the game. Governor Rick Perry watching the Aggies tonight, Kevin.
Third down and six. He's looking for his Aggies to come up with a big play defensively here. Quarterback draw. Jacobs has the first down after the 17-yard line.
That's a gritty little quarterback, I'm telling you. This team right here, I'm going to make a prediction. They're going to win 8 or 9 games this year.
I think you may be right, Coach.
I really believe that. They've got, this is a tough team they're playing. And the Aggies are, they've handled them pretty good, but they're having a hard time, and Arkansas State is to be reckoned with.
When you look at the stats from last year, Arkansas State's run, they were about 40 seconds away. If you look at the games, I mean, they were very close in several ball games. They really would have put them over the top, and they would have won the Southland Conference with a couple of breaks going their way.
Sure. Well, first down and 10 is Jamal Bracey.
Beg your pardon, Shamar Bracey out to the 27-yard line. Tough running there. Shamar has been outstanding in this game. The biggest and the fastest of the running backs. He showed it today. Maybe next week he'll be able to get his name on the back of his jersey.
Well, you got to figure that if he's playing as well as he is right now. But you know what? The interesting about it, Coach has mentioned this a lot earlier, but that Arkansas State offensive line at the point of attack, they're creating some seams and some creases. And we talked about Bracey's speed. I just don't think you look for that guy to be that quick. And before you know it, he's around the corner and downfield on you.
And the way he ran right then, he didn't take the easy way out. He bisected the two guys and,
going up top. Ball kind of slipped out of the hand, and that's incomplete. Chuck Walker couldn't get back to it. And that was almost one of those that the ball was thrown so badly that it could have been good because cornerback's covering the guy where you think he should be. And almost Walker was able to get back to the football, but it's an incomplete pass and a third down coming up again.
The big deal now, Kevin, is to throw the ball out there one-on-one behind them, and that's what all of them do.
Yeah, that's the trend.
What
now,
to work on.
It's certainly a much higher chance of completion
and knowing
than it is from trying to throw the splash over the top of the shoulder, a guy running away from it.
No doubt.
Throw it right there on the defender's back hip. And the receiver knows where the ball is. If you practice that enough, that can be a real weapon for your offense.
Third down, long two. Quick slant. Incomplete. Boy, the heat was coming, too, from both sides. And also Chuck Walker once he got the football as well. The football got to him.
Now it'll get this crowd all jacked up. I'm telling you right now, is go ahead and put a little bit of pressure on the quarterback. You're going to see him come from both sides. Boom, he takes a shot. Singleton just delivers a mighty lick to him. I'm telling you, Byron Jones was getting good coverage out there on that little short slant.
Yes, he was.
It's hard to do when you're a quarterback, Coach. You're standing there trying to throw that pinpoint pass, and you got a guy breathing right down your neck. Good job of the A&M defense.
Jason Carter back deep.
that'll go out of bounds.
Good job on the special teams there.
Left-footed punch, hard to catch. It spins the other way, you know.
We don't see it much. 8:54 to go in College Station. The Aggies on top in the opener, 19-3.
The San Antonio Spurs are NBA champions once again.
Calling for three. Yes! Good!
Celebrate their amazing victory with Sports Illustrated's exclusive Thrill Pack, featuring the official 2003 NBA Finals home video, plus the special hardbound Sports Illustrated commemorative edition. Both are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. Nobody beats Sports Illustrated's great writing and sports photography.
Take on David Robinson, that is one.
Call now and run the court with the San Antonio Spurs. Go inside and see how they did it. Feel the emotion of what it's like to win it all. Don't miss a shot. Stay in the game with Sports Illustrated and the new champions of the NBA, the San Antonio Spurs.
Rose throws it over Mutombo.
And have it all the way you want it, on DVD or VHS. Either way. With your exclusive Thrill Pack, you also get Sports Illustrated's special hardbound commemorative edition free. Individually numbered and highlighted with gold lettering, this colorful classic offers an inside look at the Spurs' exciting championship run.
David Robinson.
Both of these outstanding gifts are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, giving you 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price.
Sensational!
This Spurs long sleeve champions t-shirt is also free when you use your credit card. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it's steel gray, lightweight, and fit for a champion. Call now and get the incredible NBA Finals video on either DVD or VHS, the Sports Illustrated commemorative, and the exclusive Spurs champions t-shirt. Call now and get all three great Spurs championship collectibles free.
Jackson.
This championship thrill pack is available exclusively for the number one team in the NBA. From the number one magazine in sports, Sports Illustrated. Call now.
Well, the 21st head coaching season for Dennis Franchione, getting off to a good start tonight as his team leads with just under 9 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. 19-3. Score right now. Dustin Long back on from the 31-yard line on first down and 10 after the Arkansas State punt. Lewis saluting men at the line of scrimmage, breaks it out for a gain of 8 yards. Coach, talk about the continuity as being able to bring his entire staff from Alabama, just how much that helps. That's the first time that a new head coach has brought this many coaches to Texas A&M since Bear Bryant did it in 1954.
Well, it makes everything simple. All the things that are problems as far as the new staff is concerned, you don't have any problems because you know them all. They all know each other. They all know what their duties are. And, and again, Charlie North, the director of football operations, is a big plus. And they've made a nice continuity hire in that whole situation. And, you know, that speaks well for Coach Franchione. For all those guys to come with him tells you a lot about him and a lot about the program he stands for. And it's
prior to the snap, false start on the offense, 5 yards, remains second down.
Other thing is that you Texas A&M playing Arkansas State, and you're a normal A&M fan. You come over and say, well, we're going to beat them 50-0.
Right.
You know, they were 6-7 last year in the bad cup. And Texas A&M's played good tonight. I mean, I know that there's a few things got to be fine too, but they've played good because this team they're playing is a good football team with good players on it.
And well coached. Steve Roberts did a great job.
He's been coaching the year about four or five different times, Shay, and all over, everywhere he's ever been, he's done a nice job.
Dustin Long out near a first down. It'll depend on the spot. I believe he's a bit short, just outside the 40-yard line. As Long got hit hard, if you don't believe me. Chin straps just don't pop off for nothing. Here's the man that delivered the blow, Everett.
You don't normally expect your quarterbacks in a non-option-oriented team to be able to make that cut up field so decisively and lower their shoulder and run it. But I tell you, Coach Franchione ran the option, or at least as far as I know, certainly his last three stops.
Yep.
And it's a part of the offense that he's going to keep in. And it just basically, it's a check on the defense. It keeps them honest.
Well, the one quarterback thing, sneak, get the first down. That'll move the sticks. Go ahead, Coach, sir.
Oh, the one thing about the option play that you do, it eliminates some defenses from doing things that if they know you've got the option, they can't do a few things.
Well, and it dictates the personnel that the defense is able to trot out onto the field. And it's real. And you know, Coach, defending the option is so assignment-oriented. If you got to plug that into a week of preparation, just for five or six times a game, but you got to do it, because if you don't, you'll get lit up for a big one.
You're right, Shay, and that's the key to all of it. Learn how to play it. Takes a long time, and not many people do it anymore, so it's a great weapon.
Well, first down and 10, and A&M trying to play a little clock management here as we're under 7 minutes to go in the ball game. That's not going to help. Courtney Lewis hitting the backfield and brought down immediately. That's those big guys up front. Finally, we get to see John Bradley holding them up. And then Stephen Tooks comes through there again, that junior from Stone Mountain, Georgia.
I tell you, John Bradley's made 100 tackles tonight, it seems like. I mean, he and Corey Williams, they've been all over the field. And
I'll tell you, the big fella just fought right through there, didn't he, Coach?
Yeah, he did. He really did. And, they got good linebackers. Those linebackers have got good quickness and good speed, and they've got a nice little scheme. At 4-2 is really, really flexible. Excuse me.
He is the number 3 all-time leading rusher in Arkansas high school history.
Rusher,
Coach,
right?
He not rushed. He ran. He rushed as a running back for nearly 6,500 yards.
Is that right?
65. They're going to bring this one back.
No whistle.
Arkansas State will take it in for a touchdown. That's a play into the whistle.
That was a catch by Terrence Thomas, but boy, he took a major shot. He was running the out route, Coach.
I'm glad he got up.
Yeah, he took a big time lick right there in Arkansas State.
15,
opportunistically,
Stephen Tooks returns the fumble for it.
Stephen Tooks, the guy you're talking about earlier, Kevin, picks it up and brings it in for the touchdown. You got to play till the whistle blows. But wait, take a look at the shot here that Terrence Thomas takes. Nice job catching it.
Oh, yeah.
Just lays his shoulder in there.
What a hit!
And that's the man, Jonathan Burke. We have called his name a lot tonight.
Well, and this is going to make it a chance to make it a 9-point ball game with 5:53 to go as Tooks takes in the fumble recovery.
Well, they'll go for two, surely, and make it 8 points, and then they're within one touchdown. There you go.
We even heard the governor say he didn't like them this close.
No. Well, I'll tell you, in football now, it ain't over till it's over. The fat lady ain't sung yet.
Arkansas State burning another timeout. Here we go. Here's our man right here, Jonathan Burke. And you got Terrence Thomas coming in right there, Coach. You're going to take a look. Just breaks on the ball beautifully. Thomas, boy, right as he goes to secure it, Burke lays a shoulder into him, and then the fight for the football. Very opportunistically, Tooks picks it up. And that's how you want your defense to play. Hustle to the football. Don't stop till the whistle blows. Everybody going.
And that's that old cover two at its best, because they clue the guy. The inside receiver goes out, and the corner levels off, and he hits him. And that's a great, great football play. I'm just glad number 3 didn't get hurt.
Yeah, he took a big shot. But that's one of those deals, too, where you were talking earlier about that post corner route. When you're running that post corner on that cover two, you need somebody kind of in that flat to hold the corner up.
That's right.
Well, when he was holding the corner up, the corner played it pretty well that time.
Yeah.
It looks like Terrence Thomas is going to be all right.
Just needs to check his feelings a little bit if he has any.
Yep. Yeah, that's textbook. Right on the football, too.
Yeah.
And the thing I like about the hit, if we can go back and run that hit one more time, Coach, take a look at it's not a spear. It's not with the top of the helmet. He's a clean football play. He's hitting him right there. He's leading with the shoulder just how you want him to do.
Shoot,
so.
Yeah.
And by doing that, too, that's actually Terrence Thomas is fortunate that he didn't bear down straight on with the top of the hat.
No doubt about it. This is a big play now. This makes it a one-touchdown game if they make this.
To make it an 8-point game. Elliott Jacobs, straight drop, looking to throw, going for the fade in the end zone, incomplete. And an interference call's coming up.
Yeah.
Boy, Jackson Appel's wondering what he did wrong. All he did was swat the ball down.
After further review, you may find a little more than that.
Yeah, we'll take a look at it.
That was bump and run.
Yeah, you free safety
bump and run.
There. I'm telling you now, you see there? He did that big old A move. He did around the back. He didn't touch it. Let him play, ref. Come on, let him play.
Well, that makes it a yard and a half now. That changes the
pass interference
on the defense. Half the distance to the goal. Still one untimed down.
But Jackson Appel doing a nice job of running that man-on-man coverage. And Elliott Jacobs, he just basically lobbed it up to the corner. He was throwing to a spot. And as Appel came around, he just went with his right hand. The ref called it for pass interference. So it gives him a lot better shot here at converting this two-point shot.
Shawar Bracey dotting the I formation. Hand it to Bracey. Got in. We got an eight-point game just like that with less than 6 minutes to go. But just when you thought this one was over, Steve Roberts says, think again. It's 19-11 A&M.
All over America, people are throwing out their cable boxes and switching to DirecTV. That's because right now when you call this toll-free number, you can get a free two-room DirecTV system with professional installation. You heard right. Get a DirecTV system with standard professional installation, a $250 value when you call Prime TV now. With cable, you can pay upwards of $45 or more each and every month for basic channels and still don't always get your favorites. Like do-it-yourself and food channels. If you're lucky, maybe your local cable company will offer them. But with DirecTV service, they're already here, including the best DirecTV programming. With access to over 225 available channels featuring the best premium movie channels like HBO and Cinemax, Showtime, even Stars, Sports Pack, and favorites like NFL Sunday Ticket, with your choice of nearly every NFL game on Sundays throughout the regular season. Family programming, music choice, and DirecTV pay-per-view movies and events. Plus, you get access to your top local channels, all at a price that's a whole lot less than cable. With DirecTV service, you get digital quality pictures that make you feel like you're right in the middle of the action. And digital quality sound featuring state-of-the-art DVD quality. And now get 4 months free of DirecTV's best programming package, Total Choice Premier with local channels. That's right, you get over 225 channels free for 4 months, a $350 value when you call now.
Knock it off up there.
Call 1-800-906-9155 for your new DirecTV system. Just pick up the phone and call 1-800-906-9155 for your DirecTV system now. Offer ends September 30th, 2003.
Now, Tricks takes it in on a fumble recovery. The two-point conversion is good. And just like that, what looked like an A&M easy win has turned into a one-score game. Steve Roberts' team just now a touchdown and a two-point conversion away from tying this game up.
Coach, you had a little strategy. If you were Arkansas State, who you would not kick this ball to?
I would not. That's exactly right. I would kick it to one of those guys.
We're not going to listen to you.
Yeah, they are.
Jamar Taylor. Well, Taylor out to the 30-yard line.
That beats the 85-yard return that we've seen earlier in this game.
That has been a big weapon in this football game. You go back and look at it tomorrow, that's going to be one of the things that determine this game is a kickoff return.
Yep. Pegram with a big game today. Is Pegram now with four field goals. Good from 42, 32, 35, and 20 yards out. Niehaus got ASU on the board early on. And Stephen Tooks with that 35-yard fumble recovery for the touchdown, a two-point conversion. And that is where we stand right now.
That's a big plus for Pegram to come in and be so consistent and so good.
Reggie McNeil back in at quarterback. McNeil rolling the pocket. He throws complete. Terrence Murphy had it knocked out of bounds immediately. That's good, safe football right there, and able to pick up a gain of 7 or 8 yards on first down. You can do a lot of things on second down and two.
Well, you put Reggie on a corner like that in one-on-one route on the outside, that's very, very difficult to defend. See, one of the flex packages come in. I think this is the first time tonight we're going to see LaTydrick Riley, the 6'2", 223-pounder out of Crockett. He's in the ball game, as is Courtney Lewis. So certainly out of the shotgun, a little different look.
And Lewis hitting the backfield again. And Les Eccles right there one more time.
How many times you call Les Eccles?
A lot.
I'm telling you. You know, this is...
I get a Christmas card from him this year, Coach. He is, he's earned it tonight.
Well, he's really played well. They, you know, those two linemen, and Les Eccles and Tokes, They're all good players. Now they are.
Well, Les Eccles is playing linebacker position now, but he is a former safety and a former outside linebacker. So he's one of those guys, Coach, that they've moved from the back to the front.
Yep.
He hadn't lost any of the speed. He's put on some weight, and he's physical, and he's showing tonight that he's pretty dadgum good inside linebacker.
They go from second down and two to a third down and four. Big third down it is, obviously. Reggie McNeil wants to cut back, has plenty of room to run, and just did get the first down. Well, the defense closed in a hurry when they got there, but it's enough for the first down, and they'll move the chains. More importantly, time for A&M to take some more time off the clock.
Plus, that's the value of Reggie McNeil right there. There's a play. Everybody was covered. You know, there was no place to go, and he makes the first down. That's what makes Reggie McNeil special.
Not only does it do it, Coach, he's rolling out here to his left. He looks in there, there's nothing, but he sees this seam coming back in where there's enough maroon jersey to pick up some folks, and instead of trying to make the huge gain, wisely ducks it inside and picks up the first down.
You bet.
Knowing it was third down.
Courtney Lewis off the right side, and Courtney Lewis, well, there were defenders right at the line of scrimmage. He takes it up. Next thing you know, he's picked up 9 yards.
Good run. You know, this sounds crazy, but this is... I would imagine the coaches of the A&M, this is what they needed. They needed to have to bear down right here at the end and see if they could get back in the mode and get the momentum back and go play hard to finish the game and win the game, because this is what early season games are for. Find out a little bit about your football team.
Yep, get tested a little bit and see if you can answer the call.
Sure.
So second down and one once again.
A little too tight end look by the A&M offense.
Courtney Lewis, the single setback. McNeil on the option. Broke the tackle at the line of scrimmage and pick up a couple, maybe three. But it is enough once again for the first down. And what's important right now is when A&M needs to be moving the chains, they're moving the chains right now.
You know, Les Caney has done a great job with his play selection, formation selection,
you
as you said a while ago, Shay. He's really kept them off balance because, you know, that was two tight ends there in the flanker.
And do you run the option out of that?
Oh, yeah.
How do you run the option out of two tight ends?
And it's just on and on and on, and they have really thrown a lot of formations at them. And boy, that's hard on teams the first game of the season, and especially when they don't know for sure what to prepare for.
Well, Kevin brought it up earlier, too. A game that was seemingly in control by A&M.
Yes.
Turns on a completed pass, but a fumble. And then it gets turned into a touchdown to make the two-point conversion. And like I said, Kevin, it was a seemingly comfortable lead.
Yep.
Everything was working well. And then all of a sudden you get the fumble, and all of a sudden you got a ball game. But you're right. They've come back now. That's two third downs. We've seen them convert in this drive.
Well, A&M with one more timeout, but the time is on. Dennis Franchione and company side right now. They lead 19-11.
Texas is reloaded and eyeing that elusive title. The lethal duo of Benson and Williams powers the Longhorns against New Mexico State. Tonight at 6 on Fox Sports Net. Mike Sweeney and the Royals are in a battle for the AL Central crown as they take on A-Rod and the Rangers. Series begins Monday on Fox Sports Net. Fox NFL Sunday returns next weekend.
Well, the Aggies looking to put win number one on the board in 2003, and they lead it 19-11. And Shea Walker, Spike Dykes, and Randy McAvoy. I'm Kevin Eschenfelder. Welcome you back to Aggieland, and good to have you with us tonight.
Coach, what do you think about that play call? Right in the face of the blitz, run the draw right up the middle, right where they just left from. And if you can break through that if you can get to the next level, which is only about 6 yards off the line of scrimmage, you're going to see Courtney Lewis right there, tunneling jets. Outstanding play call by Texas A&M.
Courtney Lewis goes in from 42 yards out. His first two touchdowns scored by Lewis. He had a huge spring game, but carrying it over to when it really counts now. The redshirt freshman. Pegram is true on the point after, and now A&M can breathe a little easier. They have a 15-point lead.
But you're going to see the pressure from Arkansas State. Here it comes, right there up the middle. Lewis patient enough, and then he just turns on the jet and splits the two defenders.
You know, that's a great call by Les Kaney.
You betcha.
Just like we were talking about during the break, the blitz, if you get past that little first initial wad right in the middle, you're all away. That's what happened.
If you can get to the second level in a hurry like Lewis did on that play, you have an opportunity to take it to the house, because there's no way that the defenders lined up out on the wide receivers, they can't get, the secondary guys, they can't get there. So if you get past the backers clean, you're going to take it to the house.
No doubt.
And he did just that.
Well executed play.
First two touchdowns of the career of Courtney Lewis. Many more to come, we're sure.
What about Courtney Lewis? Now, he was a redshirt last year, but in his senior season at Houston Madison, he had 1,500 yards rushing on their way to the state semifinals, where they ended up losing to Austin Westlake.
I saw that game, and I'll tell you something, he was a big factor in that ball game.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that was a great football game.
I don't think, and even tonight, man, we've seen him get hit in the backfield a little bit because them tackles for Arkansas State are playing really well. But Courtney Lewis in high school, certainly, the first man never got him.
No.
Never got hit by the first man. He might get a hand on him or a glove, but that's about it, because he'd make you miss, and then he's showing tonight he's put on a little bit of weight, a little bit of strength now, because you look at him, he looks a little bulkier than he did in high school, obviously, and he's a tough little runner now.
Pegram to kick it away.
Good wedge.
For the 20. For the 30. For the 45-yard line. How's that for an answer from Terrence Dunbar? Those special teams stars have gone the way of Texas A&M tonight. Dunbar trying to get one of his.
Well, the kickoff return team for Arkansas State, Kevin and Coach, has been phenomenal. They have given that offense outstanding field position on every single kickoff return.
Well, the kicking game allows you to stay in a close game. It allows you to win a close game, and that's kept Arkansas State in there, and I think it's one for A&M. Because both of them have had big, big gainers on the return team.
On first and 10, Jacobs throws this one complete. Inside A&M territory down to the 47-yard line. Gain of 6 yards as Chuck Walker made the catch. Knocked down immediately.
Talking about catches made by Arkansas State, Kevin, I would be remiss. I mentioned this to you in the open. There's a building just adjacent to this stadium called the Dr. John Coldus Building here on A&M's campus. I was with him last night at the Hall of Fame induction, and he said, "Hey, you know, I'm still in the record books at Arkansas State." In 1951, Dr. John Coldus, at the time, had 10 touchdown receptions in a season for Arkansas State, which still ranks as number one in their school history.
Here comes the pressure. Jacobs gets away. Gets a block. Looking downfield. They'll get back to the original line of scrimmage and knocked out of bounds there. In fact, he'll lose 6 on the play. Back to the 49-yard line. Bryant Singleton was finally there to escort him out of bounds.
You know, this is a hot night. Both teams have really, really played well. They're well-conditioned football team.
And that's a lot of credit to the coaches and the way that they've put these kids through the two-a-day paces, because we haven't seen guys cramping up and coming off with needing water and that kind of thing. Now, obviously, they're getting hydrated on the sidelines, but that's a long way to chase Elliot Jacobs if you're that A&M defense. They had about 9 of them chasing him.
Yeah.
But you're right, Coach. Both of these teams are very well-conditioned.
Third down and 10. Big play here, guys. Get to the 42-yard line, hit as he throws, and it's incomplete, and the fourth down coming.
I'll tell you what hurt Elliott Jacobs, Kevin, was the fact that he didn't handle the snap cleanly. He was in the shotgun, and the ball came up, and he just missed it, didn't quite catch it.
Well, you see, they're going to go ahead and punt the football.
You see, they're right there. Now, that takes him up. Now, he's got no time because Johnny Jolly is bearing down right on top of him, lays a pretty big lick on him. And, you know, on third down, you got to field the ball clean. It's just like a shortstop making the play to first. You got to get it clean and get it out before the pressure gets to you. And on that particular play, Elliott Jacobs wasn't able to quite get the handle on the football.
You catch it first.
Catch it first.
Rule one.
Jared Little will punt it away. Jason Carter back deep.
They'll get away from this one. A short punt down to the 31-yard line where the Aggies have a minute 49 to kill to get to 1-0 in 2003. Lead it 26-11. The running game has been much better here in the second half than it was in the first. Courtney Lewis, the big beneficiary, as he's taken in at a couple of touchdown runs. He's got 10 carries for 58 yards in this one. A relatively quiet night tonight by Derek Farmer. They've done a good job containing him.
They really did do a good job on Farmer. That's one of the premier running backs in the Big 12, and that's quite an accomplishment.
Weaving his way. He'll be a special player right there. Courtney Lewis again.
Well, I tell you, we're talking about these A&M guys and Terrence Murphy and other guys making cuts on a dime. Courtney Lewis right there showing. And that's what's so amazing, Kevin. He's bulked up. He's put on some weight and some strength, and he's still making those cuts, going full speed. Picks up a big first down for this offense.
Well, he looks good.
And wondering, Coach, how would you grade out the A&M offensive line now? Keep in mind, they're going against these two defensive tackles that are probably going to both go into NFL at some point.
No doubt. Go quick, I think.
Yeah. I mean, they'll make it, you know, they'll probably be drafted somewhere around the fourth or fifth round. But offensive line for A&M, have they answered questions tonight, you think?
Oh, I think so. I think they've gotten better than that's gone on. I think the center's great.
Jeff Van Gardner's doing outstanding.
I think he is an excellent football player. And those other guys just get better than that goes on. And you know, 91 and 99, and they're just not making the plays they made early in the ball game because those guys learn how to play a little better.
Yeah. And offensive lineman too. That's one of the places where you can see a pretty big. You can tell week to week in a level of improvement.
No doubt about it.
You can see it there. Probably a little bit more visible there than it would be like say for a wide receiver because you expect them to catch it all the time.
Sure. And another thing, say. We haven't seen many bad plays. We've not seen anybody bust or anybody turn somebody loose and, you know, have a clean sack and all that stuff. Both of those offensive lines have played extremely well. And I tell you, they've gotten better. The Aggie line has gotten better as the game's gone on. There's no question about that.
And that will do it. Aggie faithful on their feet. It was not an easy win, number one, for Dennis Francione.
He'll take it.
But he got the job done.
I think any win's a good win.
You got that right.
But these guys were talking earlier, too. They were so teaming, the offensive staff for Texas A&M and defensive staff, they were so teaming to play a ball game because they really were just chomping at the bit to know where they are. And now that they know where they are, they're going to have to take it out and improve a little bit, make some adjustments, which you know they will, but certainly they were ready to play a football game.
We're going to take a break. It's 26-11. Your final score is Texas A&M wins the opener in 2003. We'll come back to College Station in a moment.
Bobby Bowden became a legend doing things his way.
The one thing I've tried to do in coaching is not let public opinion tell me what to do.
Beyond the Glory, next on Fox Sports Net.
Right now, on an all-new You Gotta See This. It's every skydiver's worst nightmare. When the main chute and backup system malfunction, this sportsman free-falls over 2,500 feet to the earth.
The only thing going through my mind was, oh no, I've watched another friend die.
It's a rocky ride for these mountain bike daredevils. And more often than not, the payoff is just plain painful. He's known on the drag boat racing circuit as Eddie the Thrill Hill. But today, his quest for thrills ends in a colossal spill. In an exclusive interview, superstar NFL player Adam Vinatieri talks about the game-winning field goal that sealed the Super Bowl for the Patriots.
I know I've dreamt about it a million times, kicking a game winner in a Super Bowl, but my dream came true that day.
And the anti-beauty contest. It's the ugliest face competition. The unpredictable, the unthinkable, the unbelievable. Athletes pushing the limits and facing their ultimate challenges. You gotta see this. Looks at sports on the edge.
Hopefully, most of us will never have to endure anything quite so terrifying as what